Two, one. Fuck. I just did a whole intro and forgot to go away from the starting soon screen.
Hello.
It was a really good intro,
too. They didn't hear it, so it's all fresh now. Fresh tone.
Shit. Fucking hell. All right.
Well. I was looking at chat and that's amazing. Like, yeah. But we're live now.
I'm an idiot. Welcome, everybody. I hope you're all well.
Welcome.
2 p.m. on the dot. Is there a delay? What's the delay?
Yeah, we're very out of sync. Weird.
Okay. Let me have a look. See.
Someone said, yeah, it might have been out of sync yesterday as well, which I did not have the tools to fix that. I don't know what.
Well, that's crazy out of sync. Okay. I can fix this.
We're really good at throwing our voices. Shall I update the Zero's world map? It says it's out of date.
No. Just ignore that message.
Out of sync.
Hold on. There we go. Is this better now? Ding, 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 dong, 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 ding, 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 dong. No. Sick.
Wow.
All right, hold on.
Is that before or after? Video still ahead of audio, okay. How does this stuff happen sometimes? I just don't understand.
Video is ahead of audio. I think it's NDI.
Oh, okay.
Nearly a second out. All right.
Is it a case of resetting the NDI?
Give me 1 second, everybody. Hello, is this any better? Ding, 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 dong, 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 dong.
Any better?
Yeah. It was just left open overnight, right. So I think...
Just over time, it just gets worse. Okay.
Okay.
But we're all good.
Hey, welcome. We've got some interesting news for you today. Ross has got a rash and it's spreading like wildfire, but he's happy with it.
Yeah.
It's actually making him feel better.
Yeah.
So it's a good rash. Yeah.
It's an erotic rash.
It's 2022 and I've got back into Minecraft. Mm-hmm. There, I admit it.
Yeah.
I have a problem and I'm not willing to change. I've been playing a mod pack called Vault Hunters, and you may have seen Harry, Duncan, and Pedgwind?
I think they've all gone it recently, haven't they?
Is it those three that have been playing it together on Duncan's channel? Either way, I was actually playing it before them, before it was cool, just so you know, putting that out there. And I've really got into it on my own.
So you've just been doing solo, right?
I've just been doing solo.
Oh, okay.
I thought it was designed for multiplayer.
Yeah,
initially,
but
it's actually
it was
kind of designed for both.
That's good.
So anyone, it was Ben. It's not Pedgwind. It's Ben.
Okay. Well, that's good to know, though, because that's so anyone who's watching could just jump on and just have a chill time doing this. Well, not chill necessarily, but you can play it on your own just as well as you would with friends.
I've been trying it out, like seeing whether it's something that Hat Films could do. And initially, I was like, "Oh fuck, this is actually really hard and difficult." But I really love the concept of it. But I've got past the point now where it's really hard and it's actually enjoyable now. And there will be a whole new version, I've been told, in November, which makes it easier again. Or gives more options to make it easier, shall I say. But I really like the concept of it. So basically what you do in Vault Hunters, you basically do Minecraft like normal. Mm-hmm. And there's a load of mods, but they're locked. You have to unlock them.
Right.
And in order to get access to all the cool shit in this game, you have to run a vault, and the vault is, I'll just show you.
Is it worth me logging in yet or waiting?
You can do actually. Yeah, let me just open it up to LAN.
Okay,
I'll put cheats on just in case there's a problem. So if you go to multiplayer, you should have a LAN game come up. I really hope so.
Scanning for games in my local network.
If not, then fuck, I don't know. I'll have to give you my IP.
I've got the right thing, right? I've got Vault Hunter.
Yeah,
loaded,
you got the right stuff.
0.5.
Is this looking alright, everybody? Just put the local IP in. Okay, yeah, so let me see.
Oh, I think, yeah.
Can you see it or no?
192.168.14
whatever my one is, it'll be mine. So it's 1.3.
three.
And then put a colon, semicolon, sorry. Mm-hmm. No, a colon. 64818. Try and join that. Have I completed the game first? Yeah, I've done all that.
Failed to connect to server. It's weird.
That is weird. Why can't... Why no? When you pressed multiplayer, did it come up with like a Windows firewall thing?
It did, but I accepted it.
Oh, you accepted
it. So I've opened that up. 192.168.1.3:64818.
Yeah, 64818. We could use Hamachi instead.
Hamachi, we could do. Was it Radmin we used last
time? Radmin is all right. Yeah, let's use Radmin.
I swear we used Radmin, yeah.
I need to install that. Anyway, I can show while we install that sort
yeah,
of stuff.
Yeah, just go through it.
I can explain it. Oh, wait. Don't click the top link of Radmin. It's Radmin VPN.
Radmin VPN, yeah. That's
cool. You keep going to the wrong website. Free download. There it is. All right. Yeah, so... Vault Hunters, this is my world. I built the whole thing from scratch. This. Let me show you.
Holy shit.
Okay, let me go to bed first. I took Iskal. Iskal's like the main guy that's the lead. Vault Hunters mod maker. He's part of Hermitcraft, if you've ever heard of that. Mm-hmm. Quite fucking big, actually, turns out.
Yeah,
on YouTube and Twitch.
Yeah.
They're massive. Hermitcraft has been going for a long time. Is this my little fort? This
nice.
Is lovely.
Lovely shaders.
Got some... yeah, it's really nice shaders, actually. I really like the shaders. We've got some animals here because I like to harvest them for
great
resources.
Clouds. Lovely clouds.
Look at those clouds.
Great shapes.
And I've got a... Well, look at my inventory system. This is vanilla. As vanilla as it gets. I even got little item frames showing you what's in them. Isn't that cute? So this is all the end stuff. That's all the nether stuff. It's like stuff that will fit in your hand. Armor, tools, weaponry. Oh, it's all great. Look at this. Oh, even better, I've made this. This is the best thing I've ever made. This is a vanilla smelting thing.
Oh my god.
So what happens is you put items in there,
yeah,
a minecart goes along and evenly distributes all the ores across here.
Oh right, okay.
And then this chest evenly distributes all the coal in that chest.
Oh my goodness. That is in depth.
It's because I haven't unlocked any mods, so it makes you think.
Yeah.
Like, how do I do it regular? So, for example, have I got anything I can smelt?
Well, how many mods have you unlocked so far then?
One.
Oh, really?
One mod. Yeah.
So it's not easy to do then, or is it not just...
Yeah, it takes a while. It takes a while. But I think working together actually be easier. Yeah. So I'll show you my nether. I'm very happy with my nether. Again, I built all this. Look at that. My nether portal.
How much of this was done on the Steam Deck though? Or do you...
Quite a lot. All so the building stuff. I don't run vaults on the deck.
Right.
Because I don't trust myself. This is my nether. And I've also figured out how to move quickly in the nether. On ice.
Oh, shit.
On a boat.
Wow. Is this stuff you've figured out yourself? Or
I love some YouTube tutorials, yeah.
Ah, okay, yeah.
I would never figure this out myself.
That's really fucking quick. Holy shit.
So this is me learning Minecraft, because you kind of have to in order to play this game.
Yeah.
So in order to get around, like going to the end and stuff, you can't just teleport to the places because you've got mods. You have to go there. So I use the nether, because as we all know as Minecraft veterans,
yep,
the nether is 8 times smaller than the Minecraft overworld.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So when you move one block in the nether, you're moving 8 blocks in overworld. So well, you can use like, this as like a...
Did not know that.
Get around really quick. No, you didn't know that. So
no, I didn't know that.
I'm using nether portals to get around.
Yeah.
Actually, yeah, I've unlocked a mod. And the mod that I unlocked because of it is Waystone. So I can now teleport around the world.
So you also, don't know what you're going to unlock when you do the mod?
Oh, no, you do.
You do, okay.
You do know what you're going to unlock. So you can kind of work towards a thing, which is quite nice. I unlock Waystone. So I've got these now. So I can go to... the end instantly.
Oh right, okay.
And you know what, yes, I do have an ender farm.
Ender farm,
and it's so loud.
Oh my, farming.
Hold on.
These enders for the pearls.
I told you I'm a pro at this. I've got an ender farm. I just hit their legs and it gives me endless XP.
Oh, wow.
And an ender pulse.
Holy shit. But how long would it take to actually do all of this? In real life? I mean, there seems
yes.
like a lot has been done. Yes.
The answer is yes.
How many hours?
I'm not going to say. Actually, can we say?
Well, I don't know. How long you've spent playing? I mean,
look at my statistics.
It's entirely up to you. I don't know.
4.95 days.
Right. Okay. So,
although I did download this world from Iskall's like description because it looked like a good he pre-generated a world.
Right. Okay.
Which had like good seeds and stuff. So I'm wondering if there was playtime already in that because it doesn't feel like I've done 5 days. I feel like
well,
I've done
a lot
2 days.
There's like groundwork in place. Like, you've got like a farm here. You've got
I've learned a lot
tracks in the Nether.
Yeah, so this is my old method of getting here. Now I've just whacked a waystone there. I don't know what Mr. Lockatron is. I think that might be a random village.
120 hours. Yes, I mean, 120 hours. Like, if you... So in a series, how far do you think we'd be able to get if we do that, take this on? Or is it just you're now able to fast track it because you know everything?
I know a lot now. A lot of this has been trial and error.
So rather than just
me.
Like... jumping in there blind, you've got the foresight.
I think I'd understand a lot more.
Yeah.
So I've got all my little villages as well. All of this speeds up the vault running so much more.
Yeah.
So if you wanted to enchant stuff, for example, to get them really, really good, like my stuff here, you'd have to go to a village, you'd have to breed villagers and shit, and then wait for them to have the right book.
Oh.
Or you'd have to like get like libraries and stuff, but all of these villagers have all the correct, all the best stuff. Feather Falling, Silk Touch, Fortune 3, all the good stuff, and I've put them in this little array here so that I can access everything. Even if I lose my entire inventory, I can buy it all back very quickly. It's great, and I've got so much stuff.
There is so much.
Yeah.
So when did you actually start playing this, as in like obviously 120 hours, but like
before Craig's wedding.
Just before?
Not just before, like a week or two before.
Oh really? Okay, so you've kind of just binged it.
I've binged it in the evenings.
Okay.
People want to play other games with me and I'm like, no. I want to play this over and over again. So this is the portal you use to get to a vault. And I could run a vault if you wanted. Let's try and get you in first.
I don't know what's going on so far. I tried
I'm installing Radmin.
Oh, yeah, I guess if you use Redmond as well.
What's the question, Craig? Do I know how to craft a fence? Yes, I fucking
I think,
do, mate.
I think you might do by now. It's Spitting of a Smith, wasn't it?
Let's create...
Whenever you ask him how to craft a fence.
I think the recipe for fences has actually changed since he asked last, so he's going to be completely confused again.
Is your home as organized as this world?
No.
Is it? Wow.
My home's a mess because of this
world. Because of the world, yeah. I was going to say, I'm looking at how organized it is, I'm thinking, God, like... You must be organized at home. As in, like, everything's in jars and receptacles and, like, decanted into things. You know where they've got, people do those videos of them showing, like, all the things they bought, but everything's in separate jars and labeled.
Yes. I'm not like
that. That would be amazing. I mean, it's like, I'd love for that to be my situation, but the effort and patience, I don't have that.
Well, but I'm too busy playing games to have a real comfortable... organized life.
Yeah.
So, I'm just trying to make a password. I'm not actually part of a Radmin network on this PC for some reason.
Craig's saying, do you want to see a castle you built last night?
Did you build a castle in Minecraft?
Let's have a look. You tweeted it. Is it?
That's cute.
Can be big. I love castles.
Can you send the link in chat?
That's one thing I've missed about Minecraft is building. I just haven't built.
So this is where I think you'd get a kick out of it because you can literally just stay here. You can ignore the vault running stuff.
Oh, it would probably be something I would ignore organically just by trying to build or getting resources. Let's see what Craig's posted here.
Post a link, mate.
I think he said he has. So he has. What?
Where is it?
He said, after visiting three in Scotland, last night I went live for a secret Minecraft stream, opened the server to viewers, and within a couple of hours we made oh my god, it's massive.
Wait, did you send it?
He posted it on Twitter. I'm just on his Twitter profile. That's an amazing castle. If you find it, it's pretty
Craig, meet up.
So how many people were involved in this build?
Underscore, isn't it?
Yeah. Craig Frost. Fantastic work, Craig. It looks, and those pictures are great as well. Has that got shaders on? It looks like it has.
It's definitely got shaders on. Let's have a look. Holy shit, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Let me show you one.
I'm assuming creative rather than...
Well, he had people help him, so there's a chance.
I think, yeah.
Look at that.
You want creative to be on to build like this.
Wow, Craig, that's fantastic.
It's good. Look at that. That's even better.
That's phenomenal.
On a bigger screen.
That's beautiful.
That's good.
You and your audience should be really proud of themselves. We should have a castle like that in Vault Runners.
Yeah.
Ross,
you
could
build that train station.
Oh, Hattington.
Hattington. God, I spent so long on that train station.
You did. And you were doing it manually as well.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Anyway.
Countless hours.
Radley.
Early hours of the morning. That train station.
So join a network, Ross, on Radmin.
Okay.
And I will ping you on Discord.
Join an existing network.
Yeah, I'll ping you on Discord the details that I've just made.
Go online for that.
On Just Hats. I think that's the password. I forget how many of the I've done, but you'll see.
Right, there's Luke C.
Right, so Vault Hunters, yeah? So let me explain more to the audience. You start off literally playing vanilla. So you do the entire game. The only way you can start doing Vault Runners is by building this altar here, which allows you to create crystals to basically trigger a vault and open a vault up. But the resources required to make the vault are in the end, like the end dimension. So you have to get to the dragon stage and you have to kill the dragon and go through, you know, that little portal that comes up to the end cities and get some purple blocks. So that's why you have to do vanilla Minecraft first before you can do anything else. Mm. And then once you've done that, you look for crystals like these gray ones, which are really deep in the ground. And then you put them in this altar and then four random resources come up. So this is why you need to go and gather resources.
Yep.
It's like, oh, I need netherrack or coal or feather and wither skeletons. And once you have the required resources, you push a button and it creates an active crystal, much like these ones. Wow, 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 wow. And then this crystal, you literally, like you would flint and steel on a portal, you right-click it there and it creates a randomized dungeon with random like modifiers on it.
It's a big old portal.
Well, you can make it massive. I made it this big. You can make it smaller or bigger. And then you get thrown into a vault. And the vault is like a modular dungeon with loads of different themed rooms.
Yeah.
And it applies random modifiers to the start of it. So it could make me stronger. It could make me weaker. It could make the enemies like less enemies or more enemies or certain things like that. And there could be other objectives and stuff to do. And then you run the vault. You get a 20-minute time limit. And then you either bail out before the time ends or you try and kill the boss in there and get a ton of loot.
Right.
The boss is really, really hard. I've bailed many, many times. And there's nothing wrong with that. That's totally fine. No shame.
But so in this time, you've only managed to get one mod and that's from completing one of these things.
So, I've run
these, do you get a mod?
30 vaults.
Okay.
I've died 9 times in a vault and I've bailed 20 times and I've completed one vault.
Right, wow.
I've killed the boss once.
It's pretty damn hard then.
Mostly because I'm scared.
When you die, you just lose your items and go back to base.
Yeah, so that's the bad. That's why I bail
Which
so
is
much.
Why. You've got good stuff.
I've got good stuff on me. I've spent a long time enchanting all this stuff. I don't want to lose it all. If you die in the vault, you die in real life. And then you get the death certificate and stuff. And then your family's mourning. So, and you lose everything. Even if you have keep inventory on with cheats, it doesn't work. It deletes everything.
Oh, shit.
So, but there are things you can do. So you can get these little crystals and you can get items, which you can only get in the vault to modify them. So, you know, the modifiers are random. It makes you strong. It makes you weak.
Yeah.
You can add an item here to give it different modifiers and make it specific.
Right. Okay.
And there's one that I can make, which keeps your inventory.
Oh, sweet.
So, yeah, that's great. Which means I've done a few runs now where even if I die, you at least get all your inventory back.
Yeah.
So that's that's one of the things I think is changing in the November version, is you can just have that on by default without making an item. You can just be like, even if you die, you keep your inventory.
Yeah.
Which I think is a little harsh.
It's an entertainment value, so people can still enjoy it rather than you just being devastated and then giving up, which,
yeah,
let's be honest, might happen if we lost all of our stuff.
It'll be very demoralizing
moment. Yeah. And it's like, oh, fuck, I've got nothing left.
And also, like, when you run the vaults with other players, even if one of you dies, you all fail. So it's like, well, you died? And then it's a lot of like, oh, God, why would you? You know.
I mean, when we did hardcore,
ugh.
I mean, just looking away from the screen for a second, one of us would die. And it's like, oh, fuck.
Well, that's it. Yeah.
So if all of us died, geez, yeah, that would be...
it would suck.
Quite the fallout.
So I would encourage that. When we get the update pack. Cool. I don't know when the update pack's coming, but I'm very much looking forward to seeing what they've done.
Yeah, but that, I think that, yeah, that's definitely what makes this a bit more feasible, I think, because this looks tough otherwise. As in, like, yeah, just as I mean, in that element of it.
My vault's,
I mean,
now,
the other side of it, of the Minecraft side, definitely on board with that. That sounds really cool. I don't want to die in a vault and lose everything there.
And then feel
guilty. Look at all this stuff you've got. Exactly, yeah. You've accrued so much.
I know.
Here, and it looks so complex and well organized.
The other cool thing about this, I showed you a little bit, is this. These are all your stats, but this is the tree. You can unlock, when you do vault runs, you get XP, which is specific to vault running.
Yeah.
And then you can unlock things. So I've got Vein Miner.
Right.
So you know that, yeah, that breaks all the blocks adjacent to that block, so you can vein mine all the ores in one. I've got Cleanse, which is super useful in the vaults, because when witches and stuff poison you, you clear like poison up.
Yeah.
I've got Mega Jump and Dash, which are the best things in the world.
Mega Jump? Is that why you flew
Mega
earlier,
Jump,
basically?
Look at that.
So is that to activate or just...
I'm just pressing it on my mouse.
Oh, shit.
And I've got Dash, really good in vaults.
So there's no fall damage from Mega Jumps? So you just...
Again, a while. Wow. Yes, there is.
Oh, there is. Okay.
But there's another... This is the skill tree, and then you've got passives, which is all this you can unlock as well.
Oh, okay.
So this is like you get more experience. This is Twerker, which is fantastic. I'll show you that in a minute. This is Haste, just makes all your tools swing in and stuff faster.
Yeah.
This one, Elvish, permanently remove all possible fall damage. Just no fall damage anymore. I love that.
Oh my God, that'd be great. So we can each have our own little trees.
Yeah, you get your own tree.
We have to level up ourselves.
So you can specialize in different things.
Yeah.
I've got water breathing and fire resistance, so I can walk through lava.
Oh, nice.
And I can water breathe forever, but it's working.
This stuff helps you in the vault, right?
Yeah, and helps you out here too.
Yeah.
So for example, you know that vault crystal up there? It needs like 60 wheat.
Right.
Oh my God, that's a lot of wheat.
Yeah.
How are we going to get all that wheat? I've got some here.
Get hoeing.
You just hold shift and you twerk it out and it grows it instantly.
Oh.
You know, you usually have to get bone meal and stuff.
I know, yeah. It's a low.
That's
process.
What the twerking skill does. It allows you to just grow stuff instantly. So now I've got a shit ton of wheat. Also, turns out you can go to a villager, sell your wheat for emeralds.
Holy
and
shit.
Then that's how you get endless unlimited emeralds to buy all this cool stuff.
Oh my God.
See how it builds?
Yeah.
So I've learned all that. And I've also got all my brewing stuff.
Yeah.
I know how to make potions, which are very useful in the vault. It's pretty pog.
It's very pog. There's so much organization involved.
Have you like managed to join?
Where'd you begin? No, it hasn't worked. I'm not sure
it
what
says
it is.
Ross so desk. Just, I can see you.
Yeah, I'm on. That works.
Okay, now you need to copy my IP address there.
Yeah.
And then add on the port on the end.
Okay.
In Minecraft.
All right, I'll try that.
Which is 64818.
I loaded Minecraft a second ago, but it disappeared. Show it to me. There it is.
But yeah, twerking, it only works. I've got like level 2. So the first one, it just does your basic crops. Level 2, it does melons and pumpkins. Level 3, it does cactus and sugarcane and baby animals.
Oh.
So at level 4, you can actually grow animals by twerking next to them.
Jesus Christ.
That's and good. Yes, I do have a villager breeding farm. I'm glad you asked, Ross.
Nice. Well,
let me show it to you.
Where are they? How are you breeding them? With each other?
This is a vanilla breeding station.
They're all a bit of trot inside them.
Yeah. I put a little bit of me in there.
Partial trots.
So basically you have two farmers and they farm up all these carrots automatically and they love each other very much. And then their little baby spawn pops out and falls down here, and then you've got a ton of villagers down there. And there's a bit of water just pushing them. pushing the spawn. Hold on, look. Oh, it's like, warning, villagers spawn inside. The disgusting spawn cretin. And they all get stored in here, you see. And this is how I treat my villagers. You just get a little minecart, and it plucks one out. Hello. And now he's in my inventory.
Oh, I see. There you go. Yeah, nice.
You can pick him up. There's a mod that allows you to just pick up villagers.
Amazing.
So I just put him in a box.
And then where's he? Where did you put this one?
This guy just goes in a box now.
Oh.
Nice. He's going in a box with all my villagers.
Go in a box, buddy.
Look at these villagers.
Oh, I see. Yeah, yeah. Oh, my God.
Until I need them to fulfill my jobs.
Wow.
And stand here for the rest of time.
There's so much stuff in here. There's so many technical.
I've not even shown you a vault yet.
Of this. I haven't even seen the vault.
Look at the world. It's big.
So, do you want to tell them what you said to me before as well about style choices when we get around to doing this?
We're going to do a series on this.
Yes.
And I was watching Skylands the other day. Having a nostalgia fest, okay?
It's a classic.
I've been into Minecraft seriously recently, and I've been thinking, I'd like to do another series very much in the style of our old stuff.
Mm.
And I would take on the edit again, and we'd do all the stuff that, you know, that YouTube doesn't like so much, like longer intros, music, overlays, multicams.
Yeah.
All the stuff that made Hat Films Minecraft back in the day.
Yeah.
Just have a bit of nostalgia fest with it and have fun with it and play it in this mod pack. That's my idea.
Yeah.
And you guys have to make it successful. Otherwise, all of that ambition and stuff will swiftly go out the window if no one watches it. So
yeah.
Please tell everyone. It's going to go on Hat Gaming as well. Because obviously
we've done a proper Minecraft series. I think we had Hardcore on there from... Yeah.
We did some stream stuff. No, that was on Hat Films. Like
that was the last one on Hat Films.
What's going on with
this?
So
yeah, I think that'd be quite... It'd be cool to get the intro back and the classic stuff. My only concern would be just seeing that 120 hours and realizing how far you've got, but like editing that.
Yeah, I mean...
That'll be fine. That's a task.
And then the other thing... This is where all the mods are, right? So you unlock these, and I've got waystones. But Ross, there's this whole decoration section right here.
What the hell?
Got furniture, decorator, which unlocks all these mods.
Oh my God.
You've got more lights, fairy lights, test dummies, chef. You got all the processing stuff. Create's in there, which is such a good mod. That's like one
what
of my favorite.
What do you do in Create?
Create's like its whole thing. It's so well made, and it's really hard to explain, but basically it's a whole mod. Jeez. It's a whole fucking mod which allows you to move blocks around and stuff.
Okay.
And use physics and things to make it work. It's really, really cool.
In terms of the layout of your base here, is that based on something you've seen, or do you...
I saw Iskal doing like he just made a big square like this and filled it out. But this is all me.
Yeah,
this is all my ideas, like all this.
Okay.
I'm just coming up with it, thinking about it, riffing off of others' inspiration. But there's things that you can get in the vaults which make life a lot easier. For example, you pick up these statues of people.
Yeah.
And they come with like a random block which they just shit out.
Oh, shit.
Until they run out. So this is a really good way of just getting resources.
Oh, okay. Or they just keep dropping them.
Dropping them into the chest underneath them.
What's the drop rate on these things?
I don't know. But this, like the ones with the big present, they do it for ages.
Oh.
So, but it's random. So it'd be like, oh, that's really useful. You can get a ton of marble and then have an endless supply. Look, white alabaster.
That's always been an issue in the past.
But yeah, once you get going, it's actually not too, like these are run out now. You can see they've got a little red. Red on them. Have you managed to join me?
So what's the...
64818.
Joining server. Connecting to the server. Encrypting. Failed to connect. That's weird. Wonder what it is. There's not like a whitelist or like a...
No.
Anything that you need to activate.
I don't think so.
Oh, I'm not in a different version, am I? It says 1.16.5.
Yeah, that's the correct one.
The username... I mean, if you need to whitelist someone...
That shouldn't be whitelist. _
Was.
No, I don't have whitelist here.
Okay. Change firewall to allow all apps.
Oh. Where is this? I need to do that.
Just don't show on stream. Otherwise
no, I'm only showing my game.
Yeah.
Firewall exceptions. Allow all apps. Okay. There you go. Try joining again.
Okay.
It just turned off my firewall. That's what that did. Maybe you need to do it as
weird.
Well.
Maybe. So system firewall exceptions. It says Windows firewall is off.
Well, that's what it should have done, yeah.
Okay.
Maybe it's a version thing then.
Yeah,
so
I don't know.
In your CurseForge.
Just downloaded it, so. Yeah.
In CurseForge where it has Vault Hunters, what's the little number top right on the icon?
On the icon of
Vault Hunters.
Forge, what, 36.2.23?
On the CurseForge launcher.
Yeah.
Or you go to My Mod Packs.
Yep.
And then you got Vault Hunters there, right?
1.13.9L.
Oh, you got the exact same version as me.
Okay, well, that's good. We're on the same page there.
We tried without Radmin, Craig, and it didn't show up.
Yeah,
so.
For some reason.
And you couldn't connect to my local IP. I wonder if it's because we're not on the same router.
Well, it's because we are routed through that router, but we're also through the network in the office. So it's a bit. There are. We're not necessarily on the same network, right?
Yeah, I don't know if you're plugged into this one. Are you plugged into this one here?
I thought I was.
I think we are, right?
Unless that's just my laptop, might be.
Try it without the port. Yeah, try just my IP without the port in the end.
Okay.
LAN Minecraft is a bit of a bitch sometimes. Have I tried kicking the router? I haven't tried kicking.
You tried smashing it?
I don't know why there's like graphical errors. Looks weird.
Huh. Connecting to the server. ...
It's like it wants to. Maybe it's because I got another mod installed.
Maybe.
You might mods have. That you don't
yeah,
have.
Yeah, potentially.
Oh, wait.
It might just be a different setup. I mean, I don't need to join for what you're showing, but...
I'll run a vault. How about that?
Yeah, show us. Show us what it is.
Okay, and I need to get the frame of mind running a vault. I could lose everything.
Fuck.
I don't want to lose
take
everything.
Everything? You're going to just kind of... I mean, I'm guessing you need certain
you to
things to even
stuff.
Be able to, like, fight yeah. them, right?
You have to take good stuff to survive. Well, that good stuff.
So in the normal world, how dangerous
it's just
is
normal
it? Or is it just regular Minecraft
it's regular
outside?
Minecraft.
Okay.
So once you're outside, it's like, oh, I'm out. Thank God. I'm safe again. But inside everything changes. But it's very good fun. Let me just dump my load here.
Dump your load.
Just got to put everything back, all organized. Much like my house, right? It's definitely as organized as this. Feathers. Rotten flesh. You know, you keep this shit, but you think, why would you keep rotten flesh? Well, sometimes the vault crystal needs it.
Oh, right.
That's why you keep it all. I'm just going to put that in there for now.
So
fuck
how much
it.
Did you have to watch to kind of follow, to learn all this as
I've
well?
Actually been enjoying watching Iskall's series.
Right, okay.
He both plays through it, but also explains the mod pack as he goes.
Yeah,
so that's
I watched the first one.
He's just quite a jovial guy.
Just where he started the whole thing.
Yeah, I enjoy watching him, to be honest. So check him out if you're interested in this pack. But don't know what the fuck you're doing, like me.
It seems like it was a good step-by-step, at least.
Definitely. Let's get some potions and I'll be ready to go. I don't have enough potions. Well, don't worry. I know exactly how to make them. You get three of these. You get one of these, one of these, one of these, and one of these. You fill up three bottles with water. You put the bottles in the brewing stand and you fill it with a nether wart. And you wait. And that will make an awkward potion. Take notes, Ross. Gonna need all this.
Yeah, right, there's a lot to know.
It's alright, I don't mind being the potion man. This is all classic vanilla
like,
Minecraft.
Once you play it through, you might learn a bit more. It's just, yeah, there's so many different things. And also, like, just learning all the various mods that do these things, I'm guessing.
Yeah. Oh, well, a lot of the mods aren't even enabled, so you don't have to worry about that.
Oh,
you just
okay.
have to remember basic Minecraft.
Yeah.
So that you put a golden apple on an awkward potion, that makes a healing potion. Yay.
And how many of those do you reckon you'll take in?
these three, I reckon.
Yeah.
You can then upgrade a potion of healing to a potion of healing 2 by putting glowstone on it. Yay. So that'll be even more health.
If someone was picking up this mod pack without watching that series,
God, they'd be fucked.
How much of this is knowledge, literally like, to know to put glowstone on there to do that?
Well, this
like,
is vanilla.
Tell you all this stuff?
This is all vanilla.
This is all vanilla stuff.
So you'd have to know vanilla Minecraft to do it.
Know the basics.
And of course, if you put gunpowder on a potion of healing, Ross, that makes a...
I don't know, a bomb. An explosive.
Pretty close.
Potion bomb.
Splash potion.
Splash potion, yeah.
So instead of drinking it, which takes a few seconds, you just throw it on the floor.
Nice.
And it's faster in the vaults.
Yeah.
Which we all know is...
So yeah, so in terms of combat, is it like...
It's Minecraft.
It's Minecraft style, kind of... You're making sure you don't get too close to him or smash.
Yeah.
Keep smashing it because you've. Since we last played properly.
Yeah, you can't spam.
You can't spam click. You have to kind of.
That's
been there for a long time.
But
we haven't done a proper series since that. Well, we did the hardcore stuff, I think, just like that.
It's time to detool my elytra. It's time to tool up.
Oh my god.
You scared?
I'm not scared. This is all the stuff you put your time and energy into. How long would it take to recoup if you lose? As in, like, if you die in there?
Not too
long. How long
nowadays.
Does it take to make all the stuff? Is there a certain, like, a checklist of things you need before you go in there?
Yeah. Yeah. Look. Remove elytra. Take some building blocks, healing potions and torches.
Nice.
And food. And a water bucket. And loot boxes. And if you're lucky, have a totem of undying, but I don't have one of those. So I'm putting my elytra away, and I'm getting some torches out. Actually, I've got torches. I use torches to get around in the vault. That's what I use it for. I'll show you. It'll all make sense once I'm in there.
I'm seeing your messages, Craig. Don't worry. Well, he says take Radman out of the setup now.
Remove it.
Because we do have LAN.
Okay, I'm turning it off.
Yeah, I've turned it off.
But now I'm going to... Well, it's 1.3, 192.168.1.3, 64818. But again, I don't know why you're not seeing me.
Hmm.
I'm going to... This is it. The vault
He's
is open.
He's going to go and try a vault. I don't need to join yet. It's not important. It's just to jump around and see the
jump
world.
Around.
And also, I mean, it might be a good test. But for now, we'll be waiting for that update anyway. So I guess once that update's ready...
I'm in.
We'll give it a try.
Okay. Oh, shit, it's a trapped vault. That's not too bad. But the chest that you open might be trapped. There's an increased chance.
Oh.
Which is not great. Oops. This is my routing system. So you go into a vault, and this is like one of the rooms. It's really cool.
Wow. Who built this?
I don't know.
Who's like the mod maker of this?
There's got to be a team that's doing it. But yeah, all around here. Oh, look. That's cool. I don't take fall damage anymore. So you loot the chests.
Nice.
Nothing good in there. This is like, I could sacrifice 2 minutes here to turn that into an awesome chest. Mm-hmm. I don't want to do that. If you look bottom left, you can see the time I've got left.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
You're basically just looking around. You can collect any of these blocks if you wanted them, but I don't need any.
Yeah, what's your main goal once you're in the vault now?
Just getting all the good stuff.
Yeah.
Getting all the ores that you wouldn't get in the main world, like this. Is a specific vault. There's a golden apple. That was useful for making those potions earlier. That's great.
I guess you can only fill your active inventory.
But I've got shulker boxes and stuff. Nice. And a boss crate. I'll show you that in a minute. And this is why dash is so useful. And get up. So I like to just go in a straight line as much as possible so I don't get lost.
Oh, God, yeah, right.
But you can go left, right. So I put torches like that to know that I've been... in here, then there's a big corridor. Uh-oh. Please don't crash. Okay, it's fine.
Oh.
I don't know why I did that. Now it's a new room, so I put 2 torches down like that. And this is a whole other room now. Spooky. Some of the rooms you can kind of figure out what's going on.
Yeah.
There's an underwater element here. Oh, look, it's a block of iron. That's good. In here, there's some ores, look.
And how valuable is the block of iron in terms of like the fact that you've already...
it really depends.
You can get them in your own world, right?
You can, yeah, but you can just get them as a block right now. Instead of going in the mines and stuff. Mm-hmm. the value changes, really. Yeah. But vault crystals, you know, when you make those vault crystals, yeah, they could require such random shit.
Oh, okay.
Like 26 feathers. It's like, oh, now I suddenly need a chicken farm.
Yeah, yeah.
To make all of that. So, okay, I'm going to keep going south. I don't like this room. I've got 22 minutes on the clock.
If it runs down, do you die or do you just get kicked out?
You get kicked out and you lose all your shit.
Oh.
So you've got to get out.
Make back out you've got to get back out way, the portal. Or is there another exit? Yeah.
No, it's, you either kill the boss.
Or you don't. You run back out.
Or you run back out. So
you,
that's
so you
why
need you, to know how long it's taking you to even get this far.
Yeah.
Otherwise you're like, I'm 60 seconds away from walking back to the entrance.
So this would be a nightmare if you're early. Mm-hmm. Because if you get knocked in there,
you're fucked.
You're
you
fucked.
Can swim in that.
I can go in there. That's not a problem. But it's not that good a room for loot. There's not much stuff here. So sometimes they're like hidden. I could go in there actually. See, this would be murder.
Jesus.
Sometimes there's stuff. I've seen these rooms before. There's stuff in the alcoves. Oh, look. Diamond block. Block of diamonds. That's always good.
Yeah, right.
But not very good in terms of useful stuff for me. You can get ores that are specifically vault ores, which is where all the good shit is. Let's do a mega jump. Oh, yeah. Pro moves.
Holy shit, that's a crazy jump. I'm watching with a delay. But it's a crazy jump. Mega jump.
You could actually watch my NDI stream.
Oh, is it on? Okay.
Yeah.
I'll watch through
if you want it. Instant.
Yeah,
studio
boy.
Monitor. Oh, this is a good one. So this is like a village. And underneath is a stronghold sometimes. So inside each of these rooms. Oh, it's an obelisk. That's good. So in order to summon the boss, you need to... You get like a random amount of obelisks. Once you activate all three of them, it spawns in that room. Nope!
So how are mobs more or like are they about the same?
They change.
Those basic mobs, or do you get
they get
mobs?
Harder and harder. They're mostly basic mobs right now, but apparently as you level up, more get introduced.
Is a bow and arrow?
Yeah, it's very useful. Main? Very useful for witches that throw poisons at you. But most of the time, I'm hitting with my. They still don't know doors that well, so you can go inside these things. Aha. This is what I want to do. I want to go down. Check this out. Hello. I found... Oh, shit. Is it down? Yeah. A stronghold. With really good... Oh, that was a trap chest.
Oh, shit. What's that? That's poisoned?
Yeah, it's poisoned me. Oh. Which is why I really want cleanse. Because that shit kills me. Okay, nothing in here. Let's go this way. These chests are the good chests. Ah, fuck.
Oh my god.
So the modifier for this vault is trapped chests, yeah. So I'm going to get a lot of those, annoyingly. Oh my god, there's loads racking up now. Jesus Christ.
Oh my god.
It's getting
god.
Bad.
Oh,
silverfish!
No, not silverfish.
God oh. Damn. I hate silverfish so much!
Oh,
get away from me! Okay, I'm bailing on that. Fuck that. Close the door. By the way, eating food doesn't regen you in the vault. You have to use potions.
Oh, okay.
You don't get health regen, which really sucks. That's why potions are so important.
Is it more beneficial than for one person to do a vault? Or would it,
some,
obviously
you can all do your own vaults.
Right, okay.
But you can also go in as a group. But yeah, if one person dies...
You get the impression that, yeah, like in a situation like that, one person might fall. Or, I mean, at the same time, it could help. So it's
yeah,
like
it could help, yeah. I think you just need to be coordinated.
Yeah, that seems quite tough with that amount of mobs.
I mean, I'm chancing it a little bit here, going for the good stuff. But this is what a vault run is like at this level. It's not this hard
so when
you first start.
Oh, okay.
They get harder and harder as you level up. Ooh, mystery egg.
So how long before you did the first vault?
Candy.
As in, like, how long did you... What did you have to...
I did all the vanilla.
All the vanilla stuff first.
All the vanilla stuff. So, it'll be very regular Minecraft for a bit.
Yeah.
As we go kill the dragon, you know, the vanilla way.
Yeah.
And go to the end. And then after that, you can then make the thing that allows you to enter vaults.
How long do you reckon it took to do the first complete, then?
Again, I had to look it all up. So, it took a bit. Not too long. I reckon we could do it pretty quick nowadays. So I came in from there. I think this
people
is a dead end.
Speed run it, didn't they?
Someone's...
Completion.
Oh, the completion, yeah.
You well, isn't just to you can do get it to seconds. The end of dragon. Seconds? To the end of dragon?
I think there's ways to really cheese it, yeah.
Oh, shit.
All right. Let's go a different route. We've got 17 minutes still. Plenty of time. No need to panic, everybody. This is all good. See, this is what a vault's like. It's not too bad.
Yeah, I mean...
Sometimes you get
puzzle
rooms.
It's just getting lost. I feel like that would be the...
This is why I put torches down.
Yeah.
There's another obelisk. Bottom left, you can see how many obelisks I need to spawn the boss. And that's also randomized. It could be up to, like, 7 obelisks that I need to find. But there's only 3 in this one. I could try and take the boss on. But I'm also very, very worried about losing everything.
Ah, yeah, don't lose everything yet.
But if I am going to lose everything, I may as well lose it all on stream, right?
I guess so.
With witnesses.
Yeah, yeah.
Go out in style, you know?
So how much... And Barry's played this a lot, so, right?
Barry's loving
it. They've done
this
whole
is a very
series.
Barry mod pack at the same time. Like, you can get super into it.
It's amazing. Back when we used to play Minecraft a lot, Barry was... he was anti-Minecraft. He was in the camp of just like, nah, just never gonna play it.
Now look at him.
Now look at him. He's a bloody Minecraft pro.
This is like the best ore in the game now for Minecraft, vanilla.
What was
There's
it?
There's a stage above diamond now. It's called netherite.
Oh, shit.
Which is like the best stuff in the game. And that is the best armor you can craft before you get into all the modded stuff.
My goodness.
Yep.
To be fair, yeah, diamond is old school.
It's still good.
Needs to find something that's just got the edge on it.
Yeah. You get that in the nether usually. Alright. Where am I going? Fuck it. Yeah, let's go this way.
So is that where the boss is?
No, the boss will be wherever the last obelisk is. You know that thing I right-clicked? Yeah. That will summon the boss because I've got two of three now.
Yeah.
And whatever room I'm in, it will summon it there. And the boss is also could be one of a few things. And if it's a big fucking robot, that's like the worst one.
Oh.
And I really don't want the robot. You'll just die. This is a cool room. All the rooms are really cool. I don't know.
They are like really well designed. Yeah, like it looks like a very well planned out.
They're also randomized as well.
Oh, really?
They've got this crazy how much work they put into this. Oh, fuck!
The mod pack is Vault Hunters.
Vault Hunters!
Check it on Curse Forge.
God damn, that was rigged.
This is all solo stuff, so this is just...
This is me doing my own world and showing...
World. But yeah, I think if you do want to learn it, the Iskroll? Iskull. Yeah, that's
Iskull.
His videos.
He's the guy that made this mod pack.
Are the ones that...
or helped. Or led...
Explain it well.
...development of this mod pack. They clearly know what they're talking about. I don't like these rooms, like the B rooms. I never know where to go in them. You get confused. There's multiple layers to this room as well. You're like, where's the exits? Is that an exit?
Oh my god, yeah, I would just get lost.
Okay, I came in from there because I know they're on the left, right? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I always come in on the left and I go out on the right. That's why I put torches specifically on the left.
Yep.
And I put 2 down
it's
because...
The classic rule.
Sometimes
there always are. Is it always followed?
Not always.
Not always.
No. In a panic, sometimes.
Yeah.
You forget.
Oh, shit. Witch!
A witch! Don't drink a potion. I see you down there. Stop drinking that. All right, new room. Oh, my God. There are hidden mob spawners all around these rooms. You can see where they come from. Ton of them just came out of here. Oh, I want that. It's not that good, but it's exciting. That's a modded thing. Yay, a mod thing. That's another mod thing. But these chests have been pretty awful, I will say. in terms of loot?
I'm guessing that, so you can't really just find a lot of this stuff out and about anyway.
You can't find any of the vault stuff outside. Yeah. So that's why you have to run vaults to get progress.
Pretty much to progress, yeah. You can't just cheese it and stay on the outside
like
world.
Like these candy bars. Candy. You'll see how useful that is in a minute.
Is it? How does it? Does it just fill your bar?
It's basically a power up. It makes you super fast.
Right.
So, for escaping, it's really, really good. Do I find the last obelisk and take on the boss? Oh, have I got 12 minutes?
Requesting it, but
all right, fine. I'll look for it.
Can you bail out if you're on the boss mode?
Yeah, you can just
run
away.
You can still run away.
I can run away, but it can also just, you know, kill you.
Yeah.
Before you ever make it out. You still need to keep eating because eating is how you sprint.
Right, okay.
If you're wondering why I'm eating still. There it is. The last obelisk.
Oh, God.
Oh, it's in a water room.
So there's 11 minutes 54 left on the clock.
I think I can fucking do it, you know. I'm going to do it.
Okay.
There's TNT there. That's dangerous.
You could use it.
I'm gonna hole myself in somewhere.
There's a TNT above you, behind you as well.
Is there? I didn't even see that shit. Okay. This is always a good idea.
So you're holing in.
Just dig a hole.
Building a...
And just think about your life for a second.
Oh, God.
Oh, God, I'm going to do the boss. Remember, my stats are I've killed a boss once ever. I just want everyone to know that context right now.
To run away is fine.
Don't shame me if I run away.
There's no need to shame.
No shaming. Okay, so...
Remember, there's a lot of time to get to this stage.
And in here is all my good shit. I've got candy bars. Ooh, I got... Oh, these power-up bars are really good. So you get all these in the vaults. This will give me more strength. That will give me more speed.
Right, okay.
Oh, I don't actually need those anymore. Fire immunity and fall damage. Don't need that.
The challenge for me would be just to access everything.
All my
speed.
Healing. Thankfully, when you throw down a potion, the next potion will fill that slot.
Okay.
So I don't have to worry about that. All right. Fucking hell. Time to heal
time to
up.
Get shucked.
Going to give myself as many extra hearts as possible. I think it's 4? 5? 6? I think 6 might be the limit there. All right, I'm going to give myself a power bar. And then I'm going to take on the boss.
Oh, God.
Wish me luck!
Good luck!
Fuck me!
Oh, God, is that the
He's so big!
It's big!
If you don't hit... Oh, this is actually really easy.
What are you... I was getting caught on it.
Oh, God, he's throwing snowballs
back,
now.
Though.
Fuck. Okay. I think I got this.
You haven't lost
this
any lives.
Pretty easy.
Oh, heart, sorry. So
you're... Oh, it's easy as hell.
Nice.
Yes!
This is the second one
I did
done.
It! Wait, did I get the boss crate? I think
you did.
I did.
You got boss crate.
Oh, that's it.
You did it.
I did it.
Nice. Now you just make your way out.
That was
right?
That was one of the easiest
What's
bosses.
What's that timer? Is that just a boss timer?
Once you've killed the boss, that's it. The vault's done.
Oh.
So it will teleport you out.
Oh, sweet.
So that's so the other way to...
Yeah, that is good.
...clear it.
Look at that.
Yay.
Out of 31, that's 2.
And now we get to look at our spoils, which is the fun bit too. So all the shit I picked up. So this was the boss crate I had before.
Can't believe it looked so easy.
It was
after
very
such
easy
a build up,
that
it
one.
Was like
I know.
The fact that you've done one and then
I got all of this stuff. So these vault bronzes are really cool, so it's like a currency. And then you get little vending people
Holy
in
shit.
Here, so you can spend on any of the ores and stuff that you would usually just get in the vaults.
Yeah.
So it's like, oh, I can buy these. Like apples and things, which will help me in the vaults. Mystery egg literally gives you a spawn egg of something.
Oh, shit.
Useful, though, if you need, like, rabbits or whatever.
I think that's the other thing. It's just, like, knowing all these things that you
I've
need.
I've just learned this as I go.
Yeah, like, there's so many different things that aren't... I can't
It's just
even
tons
remember.
Of content, which you can just go down whatever route you want.
Yeah.
It's quite fun for that. All right.
So what do you do with that boss crate now? You got it.
So this is all the stuff I picked up. This is the first boss crate I ever got. This is the stuff I picked up in the vault. A lot of it's shit. So I got some gems and stuff, which is useful. These booster packs literally give me XP or there's a tiny, tiny chance it'll give me an item, but it didn't. This is one of the fancy ores. These are all the ores that I've been picking up.
Yep.
These are only available in the vault. And they are used in crafting recipes for advanced things. I'm glad I killed the boss because the loot was shit. So this is the boss crate we just got.
Okay.
Let's see what's in this bad boy. Oh, shit!
So what is all this stuff? So there's
netherite leggings. Okay, so those are with enchantments thing. Already on it.
Right, okay.
Really good enchantments. I've got a dragon head. You'd have to kill a dragon to get that.
Yeah, you would, yeah.
8 diamonds. 3 magnetites, which are really good. A vault catalyst. That allows you to modify the crystals.
Okay.
A relic. Yeah, there's special armor and shit in this game, which you can only get in the vaults. Vault dust is useful for recipes, I think. Another power bar. You saw how strong I was against the boss. More vault bronze. These cookies are really good for XP. Pearls. So these are like ender pearls, but you can use it multiple times in the vault.
Oh, right. Okay.
So you can use it to like teleport around. Vault silver. That's great. And loads of ores. So not too bad. Let's have a look at this relic, though.
Loads of stuff. And I'm guessing all of that stuff's probably really hard to like even craft or get to that level of using them. Dragon breath.
So these relics are just collectibles.
Right.
And there's 4 in a set. And if you get all 4, it adds 30 seconds to your vault time.
Yeah.
So you get more time in the vault if you find all these relics. So I got like 2 Twitch relics. a warrior relic and a minor relic. If I get 4 of the same set,
yeah,
it'll permanently add 30 seconds. Or was it 5 in a set? I'll permanently add time to my vault. Vault cookies literally level me up. So look at the yellow bar at the bottom there.
So many different types of food. Is there something that you specifically try and use or get? Or
food?
Yeah, like obviously those chocolate bars are
so the primo. These bars give me strength.
Yeah.
These candy bars give me lots of speed. I'll show you.
Okay.
So this is me walking normally. And
are you farming for these things, or do you have to find them?
Whoa!
Do you have to find them in the vaults to get chocolate bars, or can you
actually make these specific bars are only in the vaults.
Okay.
So you can only get them in the vaults. You can't craft them, I don't think. No. You can't craft them.
So can you be like a vault rat, where you just go in to kind of grab a little stuff and get out as soon as possible?
Oh, yeah. That's so mostly what I do. I just go in, get grab some shit. Bit. If it gets too ropey, I'm out.
Okay.
So you could definitely do that as an option. I've killed the boss twice now. That's I am a vault rat.
That way, yeah.
Happily. All right, let's pull this shit away.
Killed that last one with such ease that
gives you hope,
makes
right?
Makes me wonder that you haven't done it. I guess you've got renewed confidence to just go in there.
I'm overly confident.
Rush in there and
now I'm going to kill everything.
It's not as
no. I've died so many times.
Oh god.
To like creepers and shit. I haven't even got to the stage of finding all the obelisks to even get the boss. So that was easy, though, because there's only 3 obelisks to find.
Mm.
That's like the lowest you can get. Most of the time, it's like 5 or 6 obelisks.
Yeah.
And there's so many rooms. You're like, well, I just never found them all.
I think that's the thing. Like, yeah, it looks confusing in terms of as a maze.
Yeah.
To get lost in.
Oh, you can get lost. I get lost all the time. I've timed out a few times.
Oh, yeah.
That happens. Got dragon heads, look.
And so what do those do? What can you do with those? Just, are they mountable? Yeah.
I think they're used in recipes. Oh, you can craft them. I don't know what they're for. I don't know what you do with them. But that's there now.
Binding.
And I'm pretty sure, actually. You ready?
Oh, what? Can you activate it? Oh, nice. Yeah. It's just constantly chattering.
Oh, you can put it on your head apparently as well.
Oh.
Okay. Vault dust. Hell yeah. Well, I'm happy I did it.
There's so much to remember as well.
Run.
But like, yeah, like
this, you just learn as you go. Honestly, this you're jumping
imagine once
in.
Once you go through each of those, like obviously you've done all the tree of the upgrade tree.
I've done quite
a
bit. I'm
guessing you would learn all this stuff just going through that.
This is 31 vaults in. So
yeah, maybe if we do it, we just try and race through the main story.
Yeah.
Get to the Nether or the Ender Dragon.
Yeah. You can focus on building.
So once you've got the Ender, so is that what just triggers it? Then triggers.
So you need to kill the Ender Dragon to unlock the end. I'll show you.
Yeah.
Real quick. because I got a waystone now to the end. So once you kill the boss, fucking hell, that it's ridiculous. I should have brought my. Oh, never mind. I'll do it manually. Ugh. So slow. So that's my ender spawner. You have to move it really, really far away from the mainland,
right,
for it to work. Because otherwise, all the enders just spawn on this land instead. So you have to be so far away that they only ever spawn on that square up there.
Yeah.
And then they run down the hole, and then you kill them. So that's that. I learnt that. But when you come to the end eventually, which, as we all know, you have to find a stronghold and get Eyes of Enders and fill out the frame.
Mm-hmm.
And then you jump through the portal, and then you're in the end, and then you kill the dragon. I've just made this to make it super easy for me to get back home. So there's the portal there.
Oh, nice. Okay.
So the dragon's here, right? And mm-hmm. you gotta destroy all the things on top, yep, to stop it healing itself. And then mm-hmm. you kill it. And then once it's dead, it spawns that portal up here.
Right.
Which allows you to access the new land. Remember we did a trailer on mm-hmm. it? The end city.
To kill the dragon ourselves manually, didn't we?
Yep. Yeah, we did. Because don't have any mods.
Yeah.
And it was on console. So even better. I don't have any ender pearls on me, which is annoying. So I'm going to have to kill one. Fuck it. I probably won't die. There we go. Ender pearl. So you get an ender pearl. This is just vanilla Minecraft now I'm doing. You build up to that thing.
Yep.
And then you go to the end city.
To the city.
Wow.
The lightsaber in the sky.
So you go through here by throwing an enderpearl into it.
Oh,
and
nice.
You remember it takes you to this, yep, crazy mm-hmm. place. And this is where you gather this stuff, which you can only get here. And that's one of the blocks you need to make the altar.
Yeah.
So that's the only thing that's locking you off from doing the vaults. You need purple blocks.
Oh, okay.
You need a block of diamond, some obsidian, and purple blocks, and you make the altar.
Yeah.
And then suddenly you can run vaults. But they've made it so that you have to do this. Just gather this shit and then get out again.
What are the shaders on this one?
This is called complementary shaders. Reimagined.
So it's not like... Because most of the textures look still quite vanilla, right?
They are vanilla. It's
just vanilla.
They've just added like fake mats
like
on them.
Sheen on them.
There's
yeah,
a bit of some well. Of the blocks are shiny, which is pretty cool. I really like the shader pack. Did I get an ender pearl? Don't kill me. I can only handle this because I've got such beastly armor.
Yeah, right. I was gonna say, fucking, usually they used to be such a pain in the ass.
They are a pain in the ass. Anyway, that's it,
that's
basically.
Basics. Once you've got to that stage, you can unlock.
You can just come back here and get all your purple blocks, and then you've unlocked the vault. You can start vault running, and it is easier than what I've been showing you, because...
you're further along.
I'm much further along. This is my vein mining, by the way. Boom.
Oh, nice, yeah.
You can unlock that.
I do love those. Well, we used to, on Feed the Beast, we had a specific tool for...
Yeah.
For that.
But this works with...
But this is just...
Works with whatever. Even works with swords and axes on trees.
Yeah.
It's great.
Because I do feel like, yeah, going back again, I'll be just learning how to chop a tree down again.
I think that would be good, though, because like we'll classic. Literally start in vanilla.
Yeah, yeah.
And then gradually build up to mods again, which I think would be a nice way of doing it. I currently have a phone call, audience, apparently, fine, so I'm going to have to take that. But here's Ross.
Hello. Hi. There's a lot of Minecrafty stuff there. There's a lot to learn, but I feel like we can definitely try and progress. I just want to build stuff, I'll be honest. I don't want to ruin it for the team by dying all the time in the vault, which, let's be honest, it's gonna happen. I'm gonna die. It's gonna happen a lot. What I'm most excited about was Trot saying he wants to do the animations and stuff again, because I think that was a big part of our content. And so, and the reason we kind of stopped doing it was because of how long it took to actually make that content. So hopefully this isn't an overwhelming project, but I'm sure we can work together and maybe not, maybe it won't take as long, but we'll see. But yeah, the other thing was whether we just try and do like a set specific days to do like a Minecraft stream. So it's just like, oh, Mondays are Minecraft, for example. So it's just like everyone knows when to watch it live and then catch up on the actual edited video, which would probably be a lot more edited down and in the old school style of just classic Het Film style. We're talking a lot of a lot of marble, I think, Pixel. We need a shit ton of marble. I just want to build a really cool building again. That's the thing. The thing is, I get bored playing on my own because it's not as fun. You can't joke around and stuff. Well, you can, but on your own terms, to yourself. So doing that again would be cool. I'm obsessed with erections. Who's saying that? Are you saying it to me or someone else in chat? Yeah, no one could see your cool shit. True, yeah, that's true. But it did take a long time to build that building, to be fair. And that was a long time ago now, so... But it seems like there's a lot of functionality to the build that Trot just showed just then. So trying to make that work within a funky tower or structure would be cool.
Yeah. There's so much potential for you to build.
Yeah.
And it's actually... What would be nice is you're not building for no reason.
Yeah.
You're also building, like, we need, like, a villager complex.
Yeah, because that was the problem last time. It was kind of like, just building a giant building for just for the sake of it, you know, because it was fun to build.
That's why I like this mod pack, because most mod packs kind of just give you all the mods.
Yeah.
And it's like, you can just play with all the mods, and it's like a kitchen sink thing. Whereas I like having a purpose and a goal.
Definitely,
The vault running kind of gives that. It's like, oh, we can work towards that, and we need to build a new room to house all of these statues, for example.
Yeah.
Like all these things.
The statues you had, yeah. Yeah, stuff like that. Exactly.
And we can show off all the stuff that we've found in the vaults. Like, for example, I kind of want to take all these ores out and have like a treasure room.
Yeah.
That'd be cool. Just to show off how far we've come and where we've progressed. Yeah. So having it all visual would be nice.
Yeah, that's basically...
Thank you, Pixel Pit.
Where I'd be useful.
That's very kind. Hello.
Thanks for the 10 gifties.
Thank you very much. It's very kind.
Yeah. Pixel Pit said, I just want lots of marble, which, I mean, is true. I do love marble, but I'm sure there's even more interesting textures in this pack.
I think there is. Oh, yeah. All the marble's there. There's all the marble there. Don't worry.
Marble's a great baseline, but we can certainly
spruce it up a bit. If you get Decorator, that one, that'll unlock all the marble. You'll get all the masonry decorative blocks, all these platform mods as well.
Yeah.
One thing I want to unlock is there's a thing called a pedestal. That requires the furniture one, but you can just put things on display on it.
Oh, okay.
Which
yeah.
is really cool.
For all the treasures.
All the treasures that we'll find. Mm. And there's actual treasures in it, which is really cool. And the whole armor system, which I haven't even unlocked. I've literally just hit level 25, by the way. Which means they're now going to start appearing in my vaults. Mm. You get randomized treasure with custom armors, and it rolls for them, kind of like Diablo, where it has like random stats on them.
Mm-hmm.
It's really cool. It's just super well done, I think. It's a bit hard, but again...
Yeah, it looks like, it's more just like knowing what to do, but obviously you've got that,
I feel like I've done enough
list
now.
There, that, and obviously the whole tree...
We're not all going in blind now. There's always going to be me that can answer all the questions.
Yeah. I think there's always... Well, it was the same way with Feed the Beast. Like, you always knew your stuff on there.
I was the knowledge helped because, man.
Yeah. I can't concentrate on things for a very long periods of time. I don't know what it is.
You can build.
But I can build, yeah.
By God, can you build?
I can build things.
This is like...
I level up the stuff I need to level up. It's more just like... Oh, if I went to those vaults and died immediately, fucking hell. It would just be like, I just feel shit about it.
Demoralizing.
Especially if it ruined things for everyone else. But it doesn't mean you shouldn't try.
No. And also the fact that you can go in, I can't use vault cookies anymore. Can't be consumed after level 25.
Oh, shit. So you've been like,
locked. So cookies are like early game to level up. So that's gone now.
You need like a pre and post level 25 box.
Yeah. So this is the Vault Catalyst. I'll show that off a sec. So I've got a freshly made crystal here.
Mm-hmm.
You put this in an anvil with it. So, and then it will give me specific... I need to turn off this tooltip thing. So this will definitely have safe zone, which means mobs won't spawn randomly around me.
Mm-hmm.
Difficult, which makes the vault harder. Great.
Wow, okay.
And slowed, which makes me slightly slower.
Oh.
Brilliant. But I know I'm... Oh, this modifier adds a random positive and random negative and slowed.
Mm.
So at least I know what I'm getting when I go into it. But...
It's just been...
That's what that does.
Much harder.
It's different for every crystal, though. So if I made a load of crystals, I could see what it does to the other ones. Yeah. Yeah. So I don't know what to do now.
I was going
to
say, what's your next target in this world?
Well, the target is to get you in.
Oh, yeah.
I'd like to get you in. Maybe I should just restart it.
Yeah, let me see. Because I don't know what else it could be for now.
F3 and H.
So Vault Hunter's official mod pack, Forge 36.2... 0.23. That's what it says on the launcher.
Yeah, that's correct.
I'll press play.
I do have access to Vault Gear now. Yeah, that is true. Ding dong.
I know, it's just doing a memory heap. It's heaping my memory.
So you can get all the villages that, you know, when you get random shit.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you need to find a Minecraft bell.
Bell?
Yeah.
Find it or you can make it?
That's in villages now. But I've found a villager that sells it. So oh, okay.
It really 36.
Yeah. But I can get an unlimited amount of emeralds just by twerking my wheat out. Just growing wheat, selling it for emeralds. Boom. I've got unlimited emeralds. Just
twerking that wheat out.
Twerk that wheat out. What's the texture pack? It's vanilla. This is not a modified texture pack. I've got a custom shader pack.
Are there other texture packs that work quite well with it? Or
I think
is it
so.
Best to just stick with...
Well, you'd have to also texture all the mods.
Oh, yeah. This is the thing. When it comes to mods, it just becomes a mess, doesn't it?
Yeah. And unless there's someone's done a specific...
I loaded up Minecraft. I don't know where it is on the... Has it gone to a different monitor? No. Weird.
Is it just not there?
It says it's already running when I clicked it, but it's not.
Oh, so I have that issue. If you bring up Task Manager and go to Details, you'll see a load of Minecrafts there.
Oh, maybe that's it. Fuck.
I'm glad I got these extra leggings. They're an identical set to what I've already got. Ding dongers. I need to change a config somewhere.
Other than the shaders pack... There's nothing I need to be able to match up with your
version. I don't think so.
Right, how many versions of Minecraft
Let me have a look.
I have open then? Too many. Alright, okay.
I could literally give you my folder if you want to just overwrite.
Let's try this first and then let's see what we can do. Use my username was_
was
because I couldn't get Raspberry and DJHUMAX is just shit. It's shit.
That is the mod pack folder. If you need to download, wipe it out and put mine back in.
Okay.
Hello, Barry. Look at my world. I'm showing off my world. I'm level 25. I'm a big boy. And I've got shaders on here and everything. This is my private single-player world that I'm showing off to the audience and Ross to just give an idea of what Vault Hunters is like. I've got a vanilla smelting system with minecarts. I've got my nice little sorting system. Well, not sorting system. It's just an inventory system here. I've got my vending machine over here. I've got my big vault there. I got my villages. Two tiers of villages. With all their stuff. Look at that. I got my brewing in here.
Just asking about your loot.
You want to see my loot?
much vault loot. How much has Barry paid of this as well? You said you were playing before he did.
Yes.
Is that true, or is that just...
Yeah, I mean, I was playing, checking out Vault Hunters before they started their series, sure.
Yeah.
But I think they progressed faster than me. Mm. I got a load of ores. I've used some of it. I got 2 boss crates because I've killed boss twice now. Wow. I've got quite a few of these vendors, which is pretty sweet. I've got a flamerang, which is amazing, by the way. It's a boomerang.
Oh, it's a boomerang.
But it's a mining pick boomerang. So I can turn on vein mining and do this from a distance.
Oh, shit. You can start whipping stuff. Does it give you the items?
Yeah, it brings the items back. But my inventory's full, so I can't pick it up.
Oh, that's pretty damn good.
That's nuts. I got a mega jump with an elytra, is pretty sweet. And dash, which means I can go wherever I want. And it's got mending, of course, so it can heal itself. I'm a pro. I'm a seasoned veteran.
So do you think your server should just show up anyway?
It should just show up in multiplayer.
Show up in multiplayer, that's the thing.
I don't get it.
Maybe Barry knows why we can't join each other.
Barry, we can't join each other on LAN. Do you have a server when you do it? Or do you do something else? Do you have it on LAN?
I imagine we would just get a... Would we get a custom server, or would we just get a PC?
I think I'd host it on a server.
Just host on a server.
Just because...
That way it's stable.
It's stable, it's always there, and you can always connect to it.
Yeah.
And it doesn't require one person to be online to do it.
Yeah, because I imagine there's probably going to be moments where we're trying to just... do something mundane to build something
if
up.
If you just want to build something for ages.
That may not require streaming.
I've managed to get it working on LAN, but I don't know why it's not appearing.
I never tried LAN. So what did you try then, George's server?
They have
a server. Okay,
they have a dedicated server, yeah. So we'll do the same thing. Might have to pick your brains for that one.
Yeah.
Fancy.
But doesn't let me...
I've given you the Dropbox folder
link.
Yeah,
I'll try that.
If you just want to delete the folder and put that one in, you'll even get my save on that.
Right, okay.
So you could open it in your own time.
Let's have a look, see.
I've even gone as far, everybody, as to install this on my Steam Deck and synchronize my saves across Dropbox so that I can continue playing this in bed. That's how far down the rabbit hole I've gone. We have added Java to our firewall exceptions, yeah. We've even turned off the firewall. I'm a fucking gamer, guys. Have we read out any subbies yet?
No, not yet. I just need a quick toilet trip, so yeah. Probably a good time.
Let's do that. Hello. Let me reload this. Thank you very... Oh, there's quite a few. Holy shit. Okay, an hour ago. Thanks, Jude, for 50 months, 50. Sorry, just got a text in. Chatty129, thanks for subbing. RDG, 76 months, Hatfilms Minecraft. What? You there, boy. What year is it? If you didn't know, I've got an idea. Whether we'll go through with it or not, I'm not sure. But I'd like to wait for the new version of this Vault Hunters, which Harry's definitely going to give me an early access version to write. Because he's got a suite in with the Iskall. Right, Barry? Can I get a confirmation in chat? Okay, that emote's enough. Systems Blue, thanks for subbing. Ultimate Ward, thanks for subbing as well. And also, for 26 months, place your bets on how long this Minecraft stint will last. A long time. Matt Harding, 123, thanks for subbing. Systems Blue, thanks for 11 months, saying more delayed than the UK's trains. How dare you? Both the trains and our streams are always on time. Welsh Ender, thank you very much for 37 months. Rai Rai, or Riri, 14687, thanks for subbing. Joe Wrench, 1023, thanks for subbing. Doug McThug, thanks for subbing for 6 months. If you were a vegetable, what vegetable would you be and why? a cucumber because I'd love to be shoved up people's asses. Ready to Dream, 84 months. La Pumpo, thanks for subbing. For 8 months, good stuff, boys. It's 2014 all over again. You damn right it is. Spacey, thank you very much for subbing. Monkey Gang War. Cucumbers are fruit. Ah, it's not. It's got little seeds in it. 60 months. Good day, gents. 5 Polygon Wizard, 15 months. Where's Smythe? Also, hello, Twants. He's got the day off. He's preparing booty. He's doing some booty prep. He was going to do some duo stream with me, but I was like, I want to show off my Minecraft world, and then Ross finished early, and he wants to see it. So Ross is here.
Holy shit, that download is big.
Yeah.
So I turn the aircon off, by the way.
Why, are you cold?
I'm cold.
Sure.
I don't know if it's... It just feels a bit chilly in here, coming from outside.
Apple has seeds. Fuck. Mike MC, 44 months, loving the recent content. Thank you. Cerberus Fetch, 500 bits. Seems like a fun mod pack. This feels cool. Get those bosses. It is a really cool mod pack. Vizmal, 20 months. A lot of the mod packs I like do for a bit, and then there's some mods that are really, really good. And then I kind of lose focus because I've always end up with the whole, well, I've done that now.
Why, yeah.
Why am I doing it?
What next? I think we kind of get to that way a lot. Well, we did that with Feed the Beast, where we got to a point where we're like, not necessarily that we complete it, but we kind of get fatigued with knowing where to go next.
Yeah, definitely. So as Vault Hunters, there's at least a common focus to unlock things. The quest book stuff, I think, is all right. Sometimes that's a little monotonous, though. Alien Lanes, thank you for subbing. Necrogenic, thanks for subbing. MarTiger88, 49 months. Thanks for keeping me sane in this job for so long. Hope you're doing well. Doing all right, thanks. Russell Carroll, while I take a big waz myself.
Yeah, sure, yeah. Oh, hello.
MarTiger88 was the last one I did.
MarTiger88. Which
was 17 minutes ago.
88. What happened to the other 87? Try appreciates it. Let me just load it up so I can continue onwards. Big up to Super Toilet Deluxe. Thanks for your fresh subby there. Pixel Pit as well for your 10 gifty subs. Thank you very much. Very generous of you to do that. Bex 4077 is a 39 munter. Say Minecraft. I woke up and it's 2015. Well, it's actually been... God, it's been 11 years. 11 years since our first Minecraft series. We are the old, dying Minecrafters. We never hit the lofty highs of the current Minecrafters. but we made the official trailers, okay? We didn't make the official trailer. We made all the other trailers apart from that one. So that's good. Right? It needs millions upon millions of subscribers and money. Who needs that? Big up to Soft Armadillo 91. You're freshie on there as well. Mr. Dunked Biscuit, thank you for your freshie. Deep Thoughts with a Z. It's a 30 munter, thank you. And that Ida is a 23 munter, thank you very much. What is chat up to now? What are you saying, chat? But yeah, I'm quite excited about jumping into Minecraft again. I think, yeah, it's been so long. Other than our hardcore sessions, I think we kind of just lost focus. On certain mod packs, you kind of just lose focus and you're like, what are we building towards? But this seems like it's got legs. Especially if Trot's spent enough time to know the pack inside and out, which is kind of important, I think. Why is there a countdown until the sun explodes? That countdown is there. It doesn't say in the title. The other day we had a countdown for twerking or... sexy bikini twerk? I don't know. It was basically the title of someone's streamer. Oh, that was it. Tiny strappy bikini squats when timer ends. This is someone on on Twitch, who, that's their title, and they are doing squats when their timer ends. So we kind of took the piss and just did a really long timer for no reason. Yeah, hot tub streamer. Oh, that was it. Smith wanking on stream. That was it. That was the one. That's what will happen. Just a casual 7,976 decades. We'll make it. When that timer ends, it's going to happen. We're all jizzing on stream when that happens. There's a goal of getting 25 artifacts and doing a final boss vault. Smith Wang. Yeah. Will we make it, though? Will you all still be there? With 7,976 millennia. Is that what that is?
Years.
That's years. That's just years. Okay.
So it's perfectly feasible.
It's not decades. Nice.
Also, I think the timer resets every time I start this up.
Oh, does it? I actually haven't monitored. Well, I just feel like it's continuously going, though, even when we're not streaming.
Okay.
I don't know.
I don't know.
It was just there, still.
I can knock off some years, maybe, if you guys are good.
I think that was that was the suggestion, that we knock off years. For this download, by the way, has taken over 10 minutes.
Holy shit.
Because it's just all those little files.
I mean, the save file I have is in the gigs, which you don't need.
Okay.
But
you can't really choose. It's one big pack.
It's just a big folder, yeah.
So that's maybe when we'd at least be on the exact same...
It'll be identical. If that doesn't work, I don't know what...
But would it not block... Will I not need to make some changes to stop it from, like, logging in as you?
No. It's literally just the mod pack. It's not, like, logging credentials and shit.
Right.
You could load up my save and it'll still be you that's logging into it. Don't worry about all that.
Okay.
Michael
Scarn will donate $5 for 1 hour to be removed. Well, I mean, sure. Sure thing.
Check this out.
Can you ping Trop's IP, Ross? Ping it. I don't know how to ping someone's ID.
Got us both on screen. Okay. And on my scene.
Hey, that's we're better. Cut in half. That's good.
I forgot I had this when Smith wasn't
sandwiched.
Around. Should we do another run?
You might as well, mate.
Might as well.
While you're in there, and I'm downloading the thing.
Do another vault run.
So what's like the rough timeline for when they're going to do this update, do you reckon? You said November, right?
November is when they're starting like a multiplayer series. Mm-hmm. I think early November, and then after that they're using that as like the test. Mm-hmm. Patch it and stuff and then release it to the wider public.
Yeah,
November 5th.
Cool.
So fingers crossed, it won't take too long. But again,
remember.
We've got a man on the inside. We've got Barry's
on the inside. Is he?
He's on the inside, and I'm hoping maybe if I'm a really good boy this Christmas, Barry will bestow me an early version.
Oh, so it's under locks, is it?
What do you mean?
As in...
Well, I want to release before they release it on the Curseforge, see what I mean?
Right, yeah.
We could get it a bit earlier, maybe. Just everyone be real extra nice to Barry. For a little bit. Then you can go back to blebbing.
Lebby Barry.
Just organizing my inventory a second. Very important. That's vault leggings there. So I found that in the vault. Actually, no, I got it from a random chest. Because I wasn't able to get them yet. Cool. Let's put that back in there. Put those down there. Gonna need that. Those can go back. Chorus fruit, that can go in my end chest. Golden apple, that's got to go back in my brewing area. So organized.
Yeah, Vault Hunters is... You can download that now.
Yeah, some you can all download asked. This version I'm playing right now. But there's a new version coming. I'll just use these.
According to Harry, most vault gear should be better than netherite.
Yes, that's the goal.
Is that
is to get
near
to
that?
Level 20. I'm at level 25 now, which means they're going to start dropping in the vaults. Before level 25, they wouldn't appear. So you have to stick with vanilla Minecraft stuff until then. Let's put that in there. I think I'm ready to go.
Right, my download's finally finished.
Congrats. Yeah, just delete the folder, put that folder in its place. Maybe relaunch CurseForge just in case.
Yeah, I need to close it all.
Just in case.
Wait, where is it? Is it in the mods folder?
Open mods you can folder? Actually, whilst in CurseForge, you can right-click and open mods, open folder.
Yeah, that's what I'm in now. And then, so Vault Hunter's official mod pack, and then...
That's the whole folder.
We're replacing the whole lot. Delete that.
Yeah, or you could just put all the contents in there, yeah. You could wipe it out and put the new stuff in. That will come with the shaders and everything, too.
Ooh, that'd be nice. Yeah, okay.
I might put a shulker box back, yeah. I'll put that in there. More space.
Extract two.
Fucking hell, it's vault time. Everyone hold your breath for the whole run. It's 25 minutes. Good luck. Oh shit, this is a good one. Resilient. Minus 30% durability. There's less mob spawning. No chests will be trapped. And it's extended. Plus 2 minutes 30. I've got 27 minutes in here. Holy shit. This is like the easiest one I could ever have. I'm going to do the boss. I'm going to kill the boss. Keep holding your breath, everybody. Keep holding. It's got an extra 2 minutes 30 on the timer, so you're going to have to hold it for 26 minutes 55 now, if you can. Thank you. Oh! Now, before you pass out, this room's really cool. This could be the last thing you see before you die of asphyxiation. How exciting. And this is where the flammarion comes in. Look at this. We can just collect all these ores from here. Ding dong. Is that any good stuff up there? Yeah. I don't know how you survived that long. How long was that? Is anyone timing that? Or was it chest in there?
I had to give in eventually.
I didn't bring any building blocks.
Where's this installing to?
Silly me.
Where is it going? Let's close Minecraft there. Let's close that one too. Just exit.
Oh, a tomato. Oh, golden apple. Oh, a patty. You can make burgers in this. The burgers give you experience. Mystic burgers.
Magical burgers.
There's some bizarre things in this. Oh, what's in here? Oh, a piece of candy.
Ooh, piece of candy.
Let's change that to that. Oh, yes. So that's a vault ore right there. Pick that up. I need to unlock Danks, which is a mod.
Dank, bro.
Which is a storage inventory management mod. It's really, really good. But maybe I'm too dank for Danks.
I think you probably are. The extraction process continues.
Is it big?
Continues.
It's a lot of tiny little files.
It'll take a minute,
files.
Apparently, but I think it keeps changing. So
it doesn't understand.
It's just loads of tiny little files, yeah.
All those little Minecraft config files.
All those little files.
What's in here? This is quite a good one if you can get all the walls.
Can someone explain what's going on?
I'm running a vault right now.
Yeah, Trot is showing Vault
this
Hunter's
is a mod pack.
Mod pack, which Trot's learned a lot on. He's currently inside a vault right now.
Yeah.
Showing you what it's like.
The whole point of this game is to run vaults and get the loot from it. Mm-hmm. I'm giving it my time.
Oh. And we're looking to do a series on this. They're making some updates soon, which will allow us to not necessarily die straight away, which will be good.
Ooh, marble cobble. I'll keep that for us. Star essence? Shit, yeah.
That's
my looting is really slow. Nether star? Those are really hard to get. A little patty? Why not treat myself? So that was a little altar there. I could sacrifice my vault time to get the loot in it. Again, the loot is randomized, but it's usually going to be good stuff. Right, the only way out of this room is this way, so let's go this. Okay.
Right, pasting it in.
These are all randomized dungeons. The loot you get in them is randomized too. Oh, wow. Holy shit. What a room. That's terrifying.
Michael Scott, how on board is Smith? Well, yeah, he was up for it.
Yeah.
Obviously, I think if we died really super easy, it might become frustrating, but...
There's a cake in there.
There's a lot of work involved. And also, like as Trot said earlier, there is... You don't have to run the vaults constantly, or all of us have to run them, for example. Like, for example, if Trot wanted to do a run...
Get your some special resources for everybody. In
whilst I'm building something, or... Yeah, it can basically become a good shell for...
Find your own focus.
For a focus point, yeah.
Get out of here.
But we can all... I mean, the risk is if you die, you lose all your stuff, and it's going to become more and more valuable because it's harder to get hold of this stuff, so...
Exactly, and the...
And I think there needs to be
challenge.
A challenge, and also something you... That's expensive and valuable.
Yeah. Otherwise, it's kind of...
It's like Battle Royale when, like, you know, the whole point is one person wins. Or a team wins at the end. Like, and it's going to be hard.
There's and more you die in real life.
And you'll die a lot.
In real life.
Trying it. And in real life. You will die in real life.
I hate...
So we're prepared...
Baby zombies.
At this stage in our career to die in real life. For Minecraft.
Yeah, we've all taken a blood pact, ready to go.
Said, look.
Said, bye.
For the series.
Family.
It's for the Minecraft series.
It's for the nostalgia. That's a rare ore right there. Look, it's flashing. You can only get that in the vault. Fuck off, mate. Get out of here. Scum.
I imagine we'd stream it, right? We wouldn't.
I think so.
I think it makes sense because it's going to take a lot of time. I mean, Trot's played 120 hours to build the world he's built here. So, like...
Sometimes I have been left on a pause screen. I
sure,
gotta get dinner
yeah,
and stuff.
But
so.
Like as a benchmark of like how much time it will take.
Worst case scenario,
it's
yes.
Take a long time to gather
to
all that
point.
Stuff. So like it makes sense to stream it and then. Yeah.
I'm hoping it'll be quick with three of us working on the same.
I'd hope so.
World. I didn't bring.
I mean,
any, oh, I do.
As long as you can delegate and explain the things that you need, we'll just crack on.
Yeah.
And then we'll probably just hopefully get comfortable with it and then end up
buggering.
We're just chatting shit and doing the things that people enjoy from our
people
Minecraft
in the world that's not in the vaults. We'll have a grand old regular Minecraft time. It's just Minecraft.
Yeah.
In the vault, different story. But again, we can build up to like, okay, next time, guys, we're gonna do a vault together. Okay.
Yeah.
We're gonna do it. And we're all gonna. This is the strategy, and you're gonna be like the mule guy picking up all the ores. The other person's gonna be the guy killing all the monsters.
It would definitely be role based. Yeah. I'll be pinging them from the back.
Yeah. I don't have...
Avoiding melee.
All right, time for mega jump. Yeah! Thank God. All right, let's go south.
All right, play. Let's see if this works straight off the bat.
Good luck! It's like a raid dungeon, yes. I've got 18 minutes left.
A roguelike.
Yeah, it's a roguelike. It's randomized, there's... progression in it. The vaults get bigger and more harder the higher level you get. I don't want any of that stuff. I do want that. I don't want that. I don't know what that is. But I'll take it. There's new stuff in my vaults now because I'm level 25. I really want some vault armor or weapons or tools. That's what I want to see. But I don't think I'm going to see them in these regular ass chests. Oh, relic boosters. Those are good. Little bit of XP. Oh, mystery box. Those are good. Heck and do.
I'm getting fucked up.
Oh, it's building up. Also, potions of healing work on monsters.
Does it heal them up?
On undead. No, it hurts them.
Oh,
it's because they're undead.
Okay, nice.
God, it's getting tough, though.
Oh, my goodness, it is.
I thought this was meant to be peaceful. The spiders are the worst. It's relentless.
Spider.
Okay,
they're always scary.
They climb shit. Make a little tower. They climb that. Bastards. All right. I think there's something in there.
A fighting arena so we can practice.
Yeah.
I'm still not in the game, no Mantis, so I apologize. I'm just loading up Trot's save version, so we'll see if
he's got the identical. Oh my god, I've got my elytra on. Oh no.
Oh,
if I die with that, that's really hard to get back.
How do you make those fuckers?
You have to go to the end city that I found.
Oh yeah.
You have to then find a random fucking village thing,
yeah,
which is really rare, and the elytra is right at the top of it. Sometimes, not even guaranteed to be there. Ah, it's just a real little
giant fish.
Yeah, I'm in an aquarium.
It's a little fish model.
I'm in an aquarium room. Look.
Oh my goodness.
And inside these fishies, sometimes good loot. I'm peeling the fish back.
You're peeling their skin off.
That's a new ore. You learn the ores. Ones that don't look like vanilla ones, basically. I found Nemo and I stripped him of his skin.
I pulled his skin off and then ate him.
Yay.
He's dead now. Sorry, Nemo. I found him.
Sorry, Nemo.
Alicia found him.
Oh, Nautilus shell. Did you drop it?
Oh, shit.
You little fuck. Vein mining is just so good. I don't know why you wouldn't have it. Give me that. I want this. Ugh, I have to drop something. Ugh. Okay, getting out. I hate those little things, whatever they're called. What are these? The fishies. Can I go in through the top? I will now. Eh. Oh god, that really fucked me up. I might put a couple hearts on. Which way did I come from? That way. Let's go straight. Those are cool looking, but
god,
they
took ages to load. All right, okay.
You finally in?
Let's see if I. Oh, I see Minecraft server.
Huh.
Is that you there?
Yeah.
Would it say that?
It will. Yeah, maybe. Is it just appearing?
I'll press join. It's got the little.
LAN.
Had the blue loading bars. So I'm not sure if it's connected fully.
We'll see.
Hmm. We shall.
Is there anything in here? Oh, yeah. Ooh. A block of diamond. Wow. Ooh, a mystery box. Wow. Ooh, a candy bar.
Wow.
Wow. Ooh, burger bun.
All right. Pair to connect to server. IO netty channel. Abstract channel. Annotated connect exception.
What?
Connection timed out. No further information.
Is your RAM turned on or off?
It's off, I believe.
All right, let's turn it on and then try the same.
Oh, is yours on though?
Let's turn it on now and then try it again.
Great. But make sure you focus on your world.
That's all right.
But if you die...
I die in real life.
You die in real life. We explained this.
That's how little I care about it.
Try to do direct
cheddar.
I'll try and join it first without the colon.
You might just be able to see it again.
Oh, let me refresh. So I can see the hat vault. Your desktop.
Try joining. Yeah, try joining it now that Radmin's on. Maybe that will suddenly make it all better.
We've had these issues numerous times with Minecraft over the years.
Yeah, the fix is to definitely get server.
Oh, for this, yeah. Well, yeah, when we actually...
This is just a temporary measure.
This is your own world, and we're just trying to jump in for now, but... So Smith's planning booty stuff. However, I don't think we're doing booty tomorrow, like planned, as he wants to get more down, basically. He wants to get it all...
Indeed.
A bit more finely polished before the next episode. It'll be next week's, right?
I think so.
It's alright, we can do some...
We'll get an update from
him
later.
I mean, I've got a fucking big old list of games we can play, so...
Big old list of games.
Maybe see if there's any more spookums to
do.
Dead
end.
But,
Oh, there's plenty of spookums. Now that
Craig's
back.
So I can get the Phasmo.
Craig, you want to play Phasmo?
I know there's an update.
He's probably not there.
Is Craig watching still?
He's probably not there. I don't think he
likes
us.
But yeah, we'll message him, see if he's up for a sesh.
He's a changed man now.
He's a changed man. The moment he got married, we lost him forever.
You ever seen Spinal Tap? Same thing.
I have, yeah.
You know when the girl gets involved?
Yeah. Is that just a Yoko joke?
I think so.
Yeah.
I think it is.
But Craig knows his Phasmo stuff and also gets
spookums with Craig. Scary.
But they've done quite a big update since we last
played it.
So that'll be good.
Like a big UI overhaul.
Yeah.
Like the lobby's all different. It's pretty cool.
Craig, we want to do some Phasmo.
You want to do some Phasmo?
Should we do it tomorrow? Should we try and do it tomorrow?
Do you want to do Phasmo with us
tomorrow? In
place
of our booty.
It's not you just editing, Al. We'd like you to be in it.
Yeah, of course, yeah.
Please.
Not just edit it, mate.
Because you're the expert.
So you can guide... He loves Phasmo. Look at that. He says he freaking loves it.
Freaking love Phasmo. Yeah,
yeah,
it's a big update.
Yeah, the one thing is, like, for us, like, obviously we used...
Proximity
chat. I guess we could do.
I think we could.
If we whisper.
Yeah.
I think we'd be
if
fine.
If you can think of a solution, Craig, for us to use...
But I just think I think realistically, if we whisper, we won't cross too much into each other's mics. But let us know, Craig, if that's because it's only the crosstalk that gives it a bit of an issue. But I think if we're just like this, like really up close to our mics,
until
like
the screaming happens, it'll be
fine. And then maybe that'd be funny. I don't know.
But I think if we just record the mixer anyway, it'll be fine, right?
Yeah. It will be fine. But it's just you get a little bit bleed. You can
a little bit
process the audio out. But it's just an extra step. I mean, there are options.
Is there anything under here?
Could have a heavy gate.
Yeah. Just cuts off really
harsh. Really harsh cutting, yeah. I don't know. He says, me and Rhiannon do it side by side with proximity. So if you're not shouting, it's fine. Okay, yeah. Well, I think in terms of ease, we'll just try and keep it to a dull
rock. Like,
otherwise,
okay,
we'll get fucking shields around us. And just
there's ghosts nearby. Got to be quiet.
Imagine for this Minecraft series, it'll be camless.
Oh,
or do you think
back to the old classic? We will be our personas. Oh, I'm a walrus! Like that.
You filthy little walrus.
Oh, I've got some blubber. Fucking hell.
I scream all the time.
That's me.
Would that be preferred at cams, please? This is the thing, like, it's hard to know whether people want... Because I find the same, where it's just like, if I'm watching someone play... any game, I do look at the cams more. So I'm not sure if that's something we want to avoid or
nostalgia though.
But nostalgia, but I like the idea of going back to what it was. What were you getting attacked there? What's happened?
That was just some thorns.
Oh, shit.
I think
a death counter. Yeah,
death counters will be in there. I think that's important.
To be fair, like for the vaults. It seems like we'll be trying our best just not to die too much, so it won't be a spam fest like we...
Like Skylands.
...once did, yeah.
Where you fall out of the sky all the time.
But there may be moments where we just die a lot outside of the vault just through our own stupidity, so... death cams were great. I mean, we've got all those assets still. It's just whether, you know, whether they want to spruce them up or... Yeah, it makes them...
Oh, Wither Skulls, so good. You get to, like... start loving certain items you hated or never even thought to care about in this pack because, like, you know how rare they are or that you need them for a very random thing. Oh, it's my first one.
Oh, oh
it's,
my.
It's loot.
Loot.
Oh, I need to put down a boss crate. Holy shit. This is getting too much.
Yeah, we won't go super old school back to the shit microphones. Sorry.
No,
I mean, I wonder if we face cam stream.
Oh, and then remove
and it. And just not have it on the... So it's like a fully edited thing. So the stream can still enjoy it the way that they do it. There's no pressure there. It's
you
just
get a different experience.
And you just... And the other side is just the edited classic style. Mm-hmm. I don't know. What do you reckon?
It's tough.
These are these tiny details that do make a difference.
It's down to us, isn't it?
Of course it is.
We'll have a deep thought about it.
But I do like the idea. I prefer it sometimes when it's off. Because also,
mates,
if we're like focusing on a task, we don't necessarily look like we're into it.
Oh,
shit.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Oh, my God.
Every time. It's always silverfish.
Oh, God.
I want to get to the... Oh, God. They just nibble away.
I'm sure we can do more construction sims as well.
Oh, there's another thing in there. I really want it. Construction Sims had a big update. Have you seen that?
Oh, is it really?
Yeah.
No way.
You can skip the tutorial.
Oh, for fuck, really? Yeah. Well, we've done it now.
Oh, God, this is getting tough.
I enjoyed construction.
No, don't blow up. Give me that. Give me all this. Oh, want that too. Oh, what's through here? Piece of candy.
Oh, that's true. You could record both, so we have the choice of with cams, without cams. Could do.
But then how do we distribute that? We upload two episodes every
I think it's more
time?
Of a case of, like,
oh,
make
no.
a decision beforehand. But yeah,
I need to go. I need to get out of here.
You can record layers, can't you? Without layers.
Oh, fuck. This is bad.
Probably not the right time.
This is really bad.
Spec. Oh, Jesus. Oh, my God.
All right. Shit. What did I put away? You in there? You in here? I think I put all my food away.
This is just stream it, cut out the editing altogether. That might help keep you interested and keep it going for a more reasonable amount of time. But that sounds really boring.
No, we want to...
As in just like, that's not how we started making content originally.
We
the whole point is like that it's a nice series for people to go back to. Like, yeah. The one downside I would say of streaming is how throwaway it is.
Yeah.
I don't like that. I don't like how throwaway it is. I like when we have a piece of content at the end of it.
Have to use a golden apple,
but I appreciate. I know what you. I can understand where you're coming from.
Regen,
because it is easier. But we have both ends of the spectrum, the stream and the YouTube channels to keep afloat. Otherwise, we will drown.
Into the abyss.
Into the abyss. We'll drown, and have to remortgage our homes, or sell them entirely.
Fuck off! Fuck off! Up. Busy lifting drinks. Up. God, really got in a pickle there.
Into quite a predicament there, didn't we?
Okay, good. Whee!
Streaming doesn't really lower YouTube views in a drastic sense, no. Well, think about how many people are watching now. 899 people are watching now.
Even if that's removed.
If we release a video tonight, the likelihood of it getting 25k in the next couple of days is quite high. So, like, that's quite a lot of... I mean, obviously, different views can drop in and out of this, for example.
Yeah, it's not...
But more people are going to see it on YouTube. So, like, the reality is it's still better to put our stuff on YouTube so people can see it. So... And also, yeah, it varies where we put it. Like, you know, our main channel now is different, so it's all in real life stuff. So that'll get different views because the amount of people who see it. I've started to post videos we post on Hat Films Gaming, Hat Gaming, onto our community tab for Hat Films as well, for anyone who just forgets that we have another nice. Channel, which is fair enough. Just so if you have started to see it more, because I saw some of the comments saying, oh, I keep seeing this posted in my feeds. And it's like, well, yeah, it's just double posted just so people get a chance to click on it if they want to see it.
Where is the exit? Uh-oh. Yeah, good.
If you could choose being more popular on Twitch or more popular on YouTube, which would you prefer? It's a tough one, but I don't know.
They're different beasts.
They are different beasts, but like...
Bit column A, bit column B.
It depends on what you mean by like prefer to watch as in like how much more. Because obviously like, I think... I know, I'd probably say YouTube just because, again,
YouTube
like
way more than Twitch.
What I like about it is you can rewatch stuff, you can go back, you can skip, you can do it for VODs on this, but I think there's something nice about an edited piece of content, which is
watching your own time, pause
watching
and play.
Your time, ready to watch it. But I also appreciate the live nature of the fact that I can talk to you directly. Like, that's quite cool.
Can't do that in a
so
video.
We get the best of both worlds by doing
a bit of both
of these things. So like, for example, if we're doing our Minecraft series on stream, I'm sure there'll be points where people point out something that we may have missed, and that is actually probably more helpful now than like back in the day. We would have recorded it, done the whole series, and been like, oh fuck, we should have done this thing. I've only just noticed it in the recording.
We've recorded 5 hours.
Yeah,
worth.
Yeah. So like that kind of feedback is, although you know some people don't like backseat gaming, sometimes it's not that welcome. It's useful.
Yeah.
It can be useful.
Especially while we're learning a new pack like this, for example, there will be things that will help speed up stuff. Look at my two torch system coming in clutch. I know the way back because of it. Ding dong.
Just come up with a message saying no backseat gaming.
I think, for Minecraft it would be fine. Ah, it's the way out. I got 1:20 to go. Ah, oh, I've got time. Where are you? Where are you? There it is. So this is an altar. If I kill monsters near it, and they are highlighted with these little flames, I think I need 6. But I don't have long left. So this is going to be a race against time. 3. 4. Where are you? Come on. Oi.
Where are you?
Get down here. Did it. Worth it. Oh god. Which one was it? This way?
Oh man. Every time I would, this is what would kill me. It's getting lost. Nice.
Did it. The greed almost got me then. It almost got me. But you can see, like, the tension, like, watching this as a video, I think it would be very entertaining.
Mm.
Like, doing vault runs is fun. And,
Oh, man, it'd be funny if there was, like, we're on the outside spectating you. Could we get, like, a screen up
in the game? Oh, yeah, where you could watch the run.
To the viewing podium.
That'd be great. Oh, I've got a Pandora's box.
A little cinema where we can just watch someone do the run and be like, fuck.
Oh, yeah.
Crystal Maze, you know how they...
Okay, you got 20 minutes.
Where they're stood outside looking through the little window. Like, come on,
automatic lock-in.
Hurry.
TLS. Yeah, we could literally make it look like that and then edit it in for sure.
Yeah. Oh, what was your... colon 6...
648 1 8.
Let's try this again. Otherwise, I think there's definitely some sort of...
Have you copied the IP from Radmin?
Yeah, that's the Radmin one.
Okay. I don't know what's going on.
But
there.
With the extension,
it might
I'm not
be
sure
a
why
port
it's...
thing. Okay, I got these.
Yeah, it might be some sort of port forwarding bollocks.
I'll set up a server for when we do it.
Yeah, yeah.
Proper.
It's not urgent to be in there. I can. Maybe because I haven't loaded it. I can load your world.
Meh. Yeah. Have a look around.
Do you have a save scum? Can you save scum?
No, you can't.
So you can just save it in a... Like
I guess...
Sent to me.
Well, auto save. Well, the save that you've got is...
I've got two here. They've got Vault Hunters. And
I guess you could just copy it, yeah.
Here we go, gamers. I don't know which one's bigger or...
We can make a cinema that works. Really?
I know that they'd had that in the game before. Is that a separate mod, though?
It would be another mod,
which might...
Yeah, it might work.
A bit complicated.
I'd like to try it.
That would be quite cool.
Just
like,
watch
just
the,
to be like,
watch
okay, what's, he's in the run.
You just put on the cinema in the background
up.
While I build this.
Just on a
this
entertainment
is good.
Value, that'd be quite good.
So if you ever like skill in the thing that you don't like, you can actually get these flasks of regret, which allows you to unlearn a skill, which is really good. They've thought of everything in this pack. I'm most excited to unveil these unidentified thingies, though. Pandora's box.
Show them.
I will show them, but I'm building to it. I'm building up the suspense. For now, you get patties and mature... Oh, vault diamond. Hell yeah. Those are really good. Lots of wither skulls, which is fantastic. Because with those, I can make the keep inventory modifier. A nether star. Fantastic as well. Where am I putting those? Where am I putting those? Oh, in here. I've got 3 now. Hell yeah. A repair core. That's new. Fully repair any vault gear. Oh, hell yeah.
Oh, shit.
That's awesome. Put that in there. Put that in there. These can all go in there. Just organizing everybody. Got to keep things nice and tidy. Because you collect so much stuff in this.
I'm going into your world.
He's going into my single player world.
But in my world.
You get to do whatever you want with it.
I've got my filthy hands on your clone world.
My clone world? He's buggering my clone.
Someone keeps saying ping Trot's IP will help isolate this issue. I don't know how.
Open up Windows, go to run, or type in run, or bring up command prompt.
Yeah.
I think you just type command prompt.
Yeah.
And then you type ping.
Do I need to
space.
Not announce your.
No, no, it's the local IP. Oh, okay. So ping space 192.168.1.5 and see if you get anything back.
168.1.5, yeah.
3.
Frequent porn.
Let's have a look. It's 1.3.
3, okay.
I'm so sorry.
Just say request timed out.
It is timing out. Interesting. Yeah,
that's strange. So then what?
So that's a network problem.
Yeah.
That we have on our hands. I don't know how to fix that.
Use Wireshark and spend the next six hours of your life troubleshooting.
Lol.
Get his local PC.
What's
ID.
Wireshark?
That's what it was, isn't it?
That was it. 192.
Hang on. Ping stats for 192. Send 4. Receive 0. Lost 4. 100% loss.
100% loss.
Jesus.
Well, that's not good, is it?
Can I ping anything on the network? I don't know.
What else we got here?
It's not important for me to join either. Like, it would literally just be.
We should get Laurie over. This guy called Electronics that me and Craig know. He's a internet wizard.
I like wizards.
I'd like them to fix everything. Can you sort out our local internet to make it perfect?
Is it the correct IP? I think so. It's
1.3. Yeah. I just looked it up.
Because I think we use them for our NDIs anyway.
I don't know how NDI is working. If this isn't, that ping isn't working. Sorry, I'm almost done organizing. Really building up the suspense now, though. No.
Snow? Certainly are, yeah. We'll get it just before we end the stream.
I'm going to end the stream now, actually. Don't have time. Oh, there's a load of shit in here. This is a panic loot, definitely. Put that in here. But this bad boy's got some good shit. Look at all this. Let's take out all the good stuff.
Yeah.
When you first look at this, you're like, what is all this shit? I don't understand any of it. But now I know everything.
Alec, we read all the subs that we get.
Yeah, boy.
So if you've got one, it'll be read out.
It will be read out at some point.
Yeah, we should do them in chunks so that it's not just constant reading.
Indeed.
But we will get to it. So if you did sub, thank you.
Don't you whiz was 7. Ancient debris. That's another unidentified relic thingy. Fuck yeah.
Just running the world on a server runtime instead of single player would probably work.
Yeah, but that's what I'm going to do.
I don't know what that means.
That means running on a server, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. It's time to start looking at this shit. My mystery box is first. Gives you random shit. Could be really good. Could be awful. Huh. Yeah. Lots of bones. Oh no, I haven't slept!
What?
Ah! This is vanilla. You know this?
Oh.
Phantoms.
Oh fuck.
If you don't sleep for a few days, you get phantoms attacking you.
Are they pretty deadly?
Nah. They just fucking scare me.
We're looking like siblings, apparently, with the silver hair. I don't think mine's as silver as yours.
I aspire to look like Ross.
If anything, I need to go further in.
More grey.
It's
deeper.
Much more of a white. Goes to white. Hot white.
Mr. White.
White.
All right. Let's open my Pandora's box. I'm sure that's fine.
And is that going to give you a beast? Oh. What's going to happen?
Burgers. Vault burgers. These give me experience. They're quite useful. And now, this is the first loot that I've only ever been able to get because I'm level 25 now. This is the good shit. Oh, it's rolling. What's it going to be? Ooh. Okay, it's just an idol. But this is like a totem of undying, so if I died with this in my hand, I'd come back.
Oh, man.
So that's like an extra life. And then, Vault Axe, please be good. I think Smith would like this aspect of it, the random loot. Okay.
Oh, big time.
So this... So you can see it's got totally different stats on it than a regular axe. So its rarity is common. It's got 3 repairs, so I can repair it 3 times before it breaks. It can level up. So if you kill a boss with this in your inventory, you can level up the axe. And the axe will add like extra features on it. But it requires level 29. So I can't use it until I'm level 29.
Yeah, how long would it take to get to like level 25, for example? Is that just...
Just running vaults.
Just running vaults.
But I spend a lot of time like building and...
Yeah.
But it's literally the XP is winning and bailing on vaults. Not dying in vaults, basically.
Well, I'm in your clone world, at least. That works. That element's working fine.
Oh, you need to Alt W the screen.
Oh. Did that...
It will do it in a sec. It takes a bit for Minecraft. I'm opening these relics. These should just give barely anything, yep, as expected.
I'll just wait can I get trotting violin? What's my IP? My local?
I guess if you just open to LAN, it will... if you press escape, then open to LAN.
Open to LAN, yep. Start LAN world.
Then I'll try joining
Port
you.
61909.
Okay.
Yeah. As it comes up, does it...
I will back out. Oh, I've got one more thing to look at, and then I'll do it. Got some boots. Booties in my booties. Oh, they're shit. Scrappy. 4 armor, but 0.2 armor toughness and 0.3 knockback resistance. So they are better. So it's like 4 versus 3. But that's like the worst kind of vault boots you can get. But they're still better. Cries level 25, so I can actually put them on.
Yeah. Change some
stuff. Look at my little booties. They look awful. Alright, let me have a look at your world.
See if that works.
696969.
I think. Is game capture sending it through? Oh, hang on. Right click. Send it
through. Oh, I see WAS.
Oh, hang on. Let me.
I think that was a Radmin one.
Project.
Mismatch mod channel list. What? We got the identical shit.
Copied yours, yeah.
Why would that be different?
Strange, it's not Is it picking up my Elgato? It's weird because I've got the game up on this right screen on OBS, but it's not sending through to this OBS.
That's weird.
That's upsetting.
Is it on the scene properly?
Let me check.
Or does the Elgato need to be like reactivated or something?
Probably let me adjust. Not that it's... There we go. That works. Yeah. Just need to be reactivated. But, I mean, Christ, it plays really smooth.
It's good, isn't it?
Even with all the shaders on and stuff, like...
Oh, it's working. I can see it.
Yeah. Yeah, I had to reactivate Elgato.
Yeah, that's with shaders on.
Yeah, it's great.
The bed is underneath.
Oh.
Through that door.
This one.
The back. I made everything locked in because sometimes you can get raided.
There are monsters.
So this is a safe, like inside the fort, nothing should attack. Oh, little fucker. Get a little bugger.
You fucker. You're so slimy and slippery. Why is it so...
Oh, you little bugger shit.
Oh my god, I can't...
That's why I hate these little baby ones.
Yeah, really quick. Really slippery.
There you go.
There we go. He was stopping me from sleeping.
You've also got all my inventory on, which is nice. You open up your inventory. You've got all my sweet armor. Yeah. You got all my shit.
Look at that.
That's weird. But it's just you now.
It's cloned world.
But it's my world. It's your world now.
I've taken over. Oh my god. I mean, I don't know how this all began, so...
Oh yeah, you're like
I've jumped in at a deep end. I'm just
it's like being given a end level Final Fantasy 14 character with all the buttons.
The fuck do I good do luck with here? That. But yeah, this. I mean, we can beautify this even more.
Faux show. Sure.
There are ways.
I made it functional, but
oh yeah, but
nice.
Like, I think that's what we
but
want.
Not amazing. But I think you can make it amazing.
We can certainly bloody give it a go if it doesn't take too long. Well, I think making it functional first and then taking the time to beautify it, but...
Yeah, we're going to be limited on resources and stuff
yeah.
to begin with, so we'll have something basic. But yeah.
Flammering. Oh.
That's it. So you've got abilities as well. Actually, no, you don't have any abilities. Press H.
Wow.
I think because, yeah, so you've got different stats because it's you.
It's just me, yeah. Nothing.
So when you run a vault, then that should be easier. Which you could do if you wanted.
Oh, God. Right now?
Yeah, why not? You got nothing to lose.
That's true.
So you've got all the shit you need on you.
I don't need to heal up and stuff.
I'd dump your inventory somewhere.
Yeah, I don't know where everything is. Let's,
go down to the bottom. Go out that door on the right there, and then to the left.
Well,
so everything's in a big cross.
In this place?
No. Go outside. Go right. Go on to the right green. That's all the stuff is. So, lay that far right chest, top right. Dump everything in the top right chest.
One?
Yeah. That's got nothing in it, so you can just shift click it all in. Keep your potions.
Any of this stuff was good here. Goodness. Power bar.
Bring the shulker boxes with you. So the blue one, that one, you can put stuff in those. Bring the boss crates. Actually, yeah, just bring that one, in fact. Don't bring the green one.
Wait, the blue one?
Just bring the blue one on its own and the two boss crates.
Right.
You can put a load of shit in those boss crates.
Do I need a water bucket?
No, you don't anymore, actually. Actually, no, you do, because you don't have my stats.
God, this is...
Bring those hearts. Those are good.
Hearty apples.
What's on your hot there? Get rid of the rotten flesh and the grass. Put that in there. Keep the candy.
What do I want to keep on my inventory?
Get rid of the potions of enchanting.
Do I need a flamering?
Yeah, keep it.
Potions of enchanting.
The bottom right on your hot bar. Get rid of that. So now you need some food. You put one of those potions on your hot bar.
One of these bad boys.
So you can easily get to it. You want food and torches. So you want lots of food. Get those golden carrots there, yeah. Get those golden carrots. Those are good. Put that on your hot bar.
Okay.
And then get a load of torches. So back out of this. Go to the into the corner where the boat is.
Wait, what? Wait.
Of the storage system. Go to the boat chest.
Mm-hmm.
There should be torches in there. Well, there's not.
There's not.
Oh, I've put them all up by the actual vault portal now, so you can go up there now. So you go in through any of these doors, and there should be stairs up. I made all that locked off because the villagers are safe, you see.
Mm-hmm.
Go to the chest on the left. This has extra stuff if you need it.
Nice.
So torches are there.
Do I need them in my inventory? Okay, left.
I'd put them in your offhand. So if you right click, fill that up and put the rest there. Sure. And then when you right click, as long as you've got like a sword or something, it will place it. So put a sword in your hand and then right click. There you go. So that's putting a torch down.
Nice.
What else? Check your inventory a sec. Get rid of that elytra on your chest.
This thing?
Yeah.
Where do I want to put it?
Just put it in the box for now.
Oh.
Oh, you put it in number one. And then on the armor stand, you want to take that chest piece to your left.
Oh, I just gave my sword.
You can do.
How do I?
I think you've take done that it. Back? You can just right click it, I think. Nice. Yeah, there you go.
But I need to heal up first, right?
Yeah, I would eat.
Just what's good for that? Just golden
carrots would be all right. Get that to full, and you should be good to do a run. Remember, you can leave at any time, and that's fine.
I'm gonna die, but it's fine because this is just a free world.
This is a free world, so the crystal's on the right but chest.
This bad boy.
Yeah, put that in your hand.
In my handy. Wow,
what? Just temporarily, anything. You'll put it back. And then right-click the portal frame. It will create
sweet
a vault. And then put that shit back. And get ready. In he goes!
I'm going in.
It's just like a simulation. Oh, treat it like a simulation. So you've got trapped and unlucky. So chests might just be trapped.
Okay.
So this is your way out. Use the torch system on the doorways.
That was...
And the mini map on the right is useful as well.
What am I looking for? Where do I go?
So this one, just have a look around.
Just have a little look around.
Just have a look around. Enjoy it. Soak it in.
I guess the thing is just to know what to actually collect, right?
But I guess if it's in chests and stuff. Yeah. By the time you come round to doing a vault run, you'll just be on the lookout for things that you just don't recognize anymore. Ooh, so there you go.
What do I want out of here?
So if you
candy bar
on the top right there.
Yeah.
You click that little button, not that one, the A to Z one. That will just condense everything down, make it easy to loot. So just take what you think is good. Like, none of that's particularly good.
Okay.
So only take stuff that looks exotic or new.
Yeah, but everything's going to look new to me, I mean, for the most part. 'Tis been so long.
So far.
I don't know which way I came
in. Not many mobs, so that's good.
Ah! Oh, yeah. What?
What that's is honey. Stuff?
Honey. Oh my god.
You're in like a honey hive room. You will take full damage because you don't have that skill.
Yeah, I don't
skill,
have the skills.
Which is why I gave you a water bucket. There's a pro strat to place down water as you fall. You can place it on the block below you just before you hit the ground.
Wow.
Oh, the mobs are really easy.
Because it's down, your first. I'm weak. I'm weak source. So that's where I came from. Let's go straight.
So yeah, on your minimap you can see that there's three exits.
Okay.
That you could take.
Let's go straight across. Look around.
The corridors won't have anything in them, so you don't have to worry about looting in the corridors. Just worry about monsters.
Cut down.
Yeah, you've got take like the best vanilla sword in the game, and you're also level zero.
It's doing that thing. It's got a little hiccup.
Yeah. There's an obelisk there.
Oh my.
How many do you need to get?
Five.
And maybe don't do a boss for your first run ever.
Maybe not. Five, though. That seems quite...
That's quite a lot. This is why I don't ever really do bosses. There's a lot. So that's the way out.
Is that the way I came?
No, this is another way.
It's a different way out, okay.
You can see how easy it is to get lost.
Yeah, oh, it's like that's going to be the main problem, I think. Well,
that's why I bring a ton of torches with me.
Dying will be the main problem, but also just... trying to get out.
This room seems to suck because it's got a lot of soul sand, which is slowing you down. You can break through things if you think maybe that will have like ore inside it or something. Usually it will. Sometimes it doesn't. Thing. Yeah, try. Okay, so that's got compressed blocks, which is actually quite useful. You think it's not, but that's compressed cobble. And sometimes a vault crystal will be like, go collect 1,000 cobble. And you've already got it. That shit's just decorative. Sometimes there's nothing in there like that one. It's just the way it goes. I don't know what this room's trying to be.
Yeah, so what would I do?
Right click. Yeah. So you've done one of five.
Like this thing looks like.
I could have stuff in it. Yeah.
What would I need for? What?
I didn't bring an axe with you, unfortunately.
This is embarrassing.
Maybe there's nothing in there.
Fuck it.
It's not worth it. You could flammerang it, maybe.
Blabbering.
Wait, right click.
Hang on.
It's a barrel, that's why. Get a bit further away.
Oh, nice. You can bop him
off.
Oh,
you can hit them with it. That's pretty good.
Ah, he's dead.
Nice.
Take that, bastard. Oh.
You don't have water breathing as well, so be careful of that.
Okay.
Maybe go to a different room.
Screw you.
Oh, yeah, get out of there. These guys suck.
Yeah.
The tridents hurt really bad.
I'm going to swim away somewhere. There's a trident.
Go up there.
Can I use the tridents?
No. It's kind of like arrows. They just, they're just visually there.
What's this?
Oh, there's something up on the right there. Oh, God, loads of monsters.
Take some of these hits. Pow, pow, pow.
Is there anything in
there? How many times can I use this fucking before it's bust?
Oh, it mends itself.
So
every time you're hitting a monster...
Look at these fuckers.
It takes some of that XP to heal itself.
Oh, God.
It's all right. You haven't used a single potion yet.
Oh, God.
I'd get out of this room because it sucks. Yeah.
Just trying to figure my way out. Was this it, wasn't it?
Just upwards. You got to go up first.
Way.
There you go. Through one of those.
Through here. Let's get out this way.
I don't know how you're going to find your way back.
No.
You've abandoned the torch system.
I've lost. The torch system was...
It's gone.
A one use.
You've got 20 minutes left. You've got plenty of time.
Right.
You've only done 5. Interesting room. Oh, very confusing.
Very big.
Look for chests.
Let's probably mark the wall.
That you came in on, yeah.
If that helps.
Yeah.
That's going to take some remembering.
That's a chest. Oh, little fucker.
Little bastard.
You'll notice the zombies and stuff are easier than the vanilla world.
Oh, really?
Because you're killing them with one hit.
Yeah, that's
just because you're low level, which is quite nice.
All right, what do we go for here? Oh! You fucking bastard.
Nothing particularly good in there from what I could see.
No.
Oh, there's star essence. That's really good.
Ooh.
You'll want to loot stuff like that. That gives you the resources needed to unlock mods.
Oh, my.
So star essence is good for that.
Right, let's see. Where are we now?
Now you're leaving.
This is the exit, is it?
Yeah. But that's fine. That room kind of sucks too for navigating.
Well, this room. It does.
There's not much in here either.
Take that. One hit. It's the dream.
You're surviving pretty good.
I've got low. Wow. Should I just. It's all right.
No. I think you'd get more likely to get lost than be killed.
I think that seems... Whoa, look at this thing.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Well, there's an obelisk in this one too.
You see someone built like a city. It was on... Like a huge city. Like it took them like 2.5 years to build the airport. Like.
Jesus Christ. Like a one-to-one recreation.
But it was a still image on Reddit. It's quite low res as well.
Yeah, this took me years. Pixel count. I don't know how to take a screenshot.
Why is it so pixely? No, it's just because it was...
Minecraft. I see.
But it looked pretty cool. Impressively big.
I think all the loot in this one is like the layer underneath, but it's hard to get to without building blocks and stuff.
Well, I've got two of these obelisks. Can I go straight?
Well, that's a dead end.
Dead end. Let's go that way.
Yeah. I think there is like a shape to these vaults which you can memorize, but... They're so big. Oh, another obelisk.
Bastard.
He's on his way to a boss fight. Oh, you went past a chest there.
Big boss fight. I'll go get it in a second. Let's go.
Don't forget, when you right-click the last one, it just instantly summons the boss.
Oh.
Just a warning there.
How many have I got? 3.
3 of 5. That's a trap chest. Get away from the poison.
Choking me. What do I do here?
Just wait for the poison to go away. And
should
then
I need to eat.
You can eat to get that back, but it won't regen your health, fortunately. Not in a vault.
No.
It's just potions from here. Just splash that on the ground when you want to. There you go. You're all good again.
Fresh.
Oh, apparently there's stuff in that ceiling eyeball. But again, you have to build up to it and stuff.
Huh. Take a hit, bitch.
The witches suck.
This
is why I bought cleanse, because it gets rid of poison. You just learn by doing.
I'm getting fucked over.
Oh, the witches. You can just run away from them as well, because they suck.
Please, my boomerang on them. I'm getting poisoned a lot here.
Yeah.
I need to wait for... Oh, fuck me.
Well, if you use your potion, you'll still be poisoned. So it will kind of be redundant. Oh, you found a secret.
I thought there's some sort of secret. Am I going to die here?
Poison will never fully kill you, but it will bring you down to half a heart. Ugh. So that is another secret which I've never... You can find keys to unlock, and there's treasure in there.
Oh, right. So I can't just force
you. You can't just force your way in. You have to find a key that matches the color of the door.
Oh, that's quite cool.
Yeah. There's lots of little...
Cool secrets, things. Which is...
I like it.
Good to try and remember those things when you're rushing in here. Indeed. I need to find a key.
You kind of have to do little runs to just slowly piece together your knowledge of everything. Oh.
Take that.
Oh.
Oh, it's a fucking joke.
This is a trapped crystal. You're more than likely going to get trapped stuff, unfortunately. Oh, is that another obelisk in there? I see it. I see the particles.
Let's just do it. Let's fucking do it. Last.
You got one more.
Let's go. So come on, gamers.
If you press M.
Yeah.
It doesn't show you the map, but it does show you where you've been.
The breadcrumb trail.
Which is kind of useful for retracing your steps if you get lost.
Ooh. That is useful. A little breadcrumb trail.
In a pinch.
Hansel and Gretel. Ooh, what's good in here?
Mostly vanilla shit there.
Vanilla shit. No,
we're
thank
not
you.
Interested. I guess you're not going to get great loot. You're low level.
Again, yeah. What's this?
Golden apple is fantastic.
Fucking cool.
Oh yeah, try firing there. Fucking. Ah.
Do I? Ooh.
Just don't aim it at yourself or the ground. Mm. Okay, you could probably fire at these guys.
Oh.
Just get some distance first, or fire at the witch.
Oh,
that's what it does. It tears everything in front of it apart.
Wow.
Look at that.
Fucking hell. Everything.
It's really powerful.
Oh my god, am I going to die?
Throw down a potion.
Ah.
Oh no.
I threw it onto the ground. I'm on... It's...
Oh god.
This is it.
This is it. Say goodbye to your shit.
Ah.
Run away.
Got it on the way out. Christ.
Maybe build yourself a little nook that no one can get in.
This will be my nook.
Oh, okay. Wait, what the in the fuck? Corridor. It's you could place some blocks now. Yeah.
Bye.
I think you're safe.
Yep. There we go. Safety.
Now, see if there's anything in your inventory to help you out here. I'm a little...
A hearty apple?
Yeah, hearty apples will give you extra hearts.
I don't want to pick up these bits.
You could put a boss crate down.
Oh, wait, what are these? Oh, these are bonus hearts.
These are giving you extra hearts on top, yeah, but they are hearts nonetheless.
Okay.
You can do 5, I think.
Okay.
I think that's it.
And then what else have we got here? We got a power bar, strength.
That's just strength. The blue shulker chest will have stuff in it that you can use.
Oh, do I need to place that
down? You do need to place it, though.
Perfect.
That's all right. No one can get in there.
Oh.
It's a half slab. You're good.
All right.
You're fine. Just put the blue shulker down there.
Blue shulker.
And hope that there's something in there that can help you out.
Cobalt apple? Jade apple. Gives you haste.
God. No potions.
Bled. But no potions. I can just destroy this and pick it up, right?
Yeah.
If I've got space. I don't need this concrete.
Yeah, again, you can put down a boss crate or something and just load it up with shit, but I think things aren't looking good.
We're traveling through the walls.
That's fair.
Oh, fuck.
Anything to survive. Ah! Oh, god, a witch. Literally the worst.
You
just keep going down the corridor.
We're going down one.
Solid plan.
We're evading. Ah!
Oh, no.
An opening. We're going down 2.
You have 11 minutes.
Fuck. How do I get back? Hansel.
Do you remember the way back?
No, I don't remember where I am. I don't know where I am now. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. The breadcrumb runs out, by the way.
Fuck, it does. Jesus.
You might have to just fucking peg it.
Oh, God.
Dude, you got extra hearts right now. You just don't want to get poisoned because that sucks. Creeper on the right.
Run.
So that's one of those altars you can sacrifice time to get stuff, which I wouldn't do.
How do I get freedom? Is this the way? Actually, wait. I recognize this hallway, but I mean, it could be.
They could be copies.
Yuppie.
You got to hope that you see one of your torches on the walls.
Oh, you bastard. You touched me. Oh, don't do that.
Oh, there's a mystery box in there, though.
Yeah.
Greed. Oh. Top right. Greed will kill us.
Gently press.
No, you've not been in this room
not
before.
Not this way. Oh, this is all fresh. Bloody hell. But do I go back the way I came? Does it loop round in any way? Is there a...
It does loop round.
If I went this way and then maybe right?
Yeah, you could try.
God.
It's bigger than just a loop, though. Yeah, it's like a grid, so... You could be well and truly fucked here.
Oh, wait, there's another one.
Wait,
it's the obelisk.
This is the last...
Oh, fuck it, God. Let's get killed by...
Oh, fuck, it's a really killed. Bad
fuck.
One.
Let's get killed by Megatron. Oh, no. Oh, I'm not dead yet.
If you don't hit him in a certain amount of time, he starts healing back up.
Oh, okay.
So you have to constantly wail on him. God, it's a really bad
oh,
boss.
Oh, fuck.
Don't forget you got hearty apples.
Ugh.
Gobble it's not actually down. Hurting you that much.
Yeah, gobble those down.
Nice.
Well, I guess it's like a low level.
Wail on
right?
him. Wail on him. Kill him. Hang if on, you he's... kill him, you can exit the vault.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, where has he gone? I hate
don't
the
you
float.
Fucking get me.
He's above. He's a floor above. I don't know how you're going to get to
oh,
him.
That witch.
Yeah, fuck that witch.
Oh, I won't give her the satisfaction of fucking her. Yeah, don't look at me.
Where's that boss gone? Oh, is he there on the right there? Oh, no.
I'm here. Oh,
oh right there he is. Kill him.
Die.
Gentle pulses. Just
gentle pulses.
Pulses of the clicks.
But the... The witch is having a go at me too.
All right. Get hearty apples on the go. Hearty apples. That's it. That's it. Keep eating. Keep eating. Keep eating. Now you need to go back and hit the monster before he starts healing.
Uh-huh.
Hit him once. At least once.
You fucker.
Where'd he go?
Where'd you go, you fucker? Oh, you are... You
the
are
witch
pissing
needs
me
to
off.
Die. The witch needs to die. Yes. Now more hearty apples.
Oh, God, I'm heartying.
That's it. And then hit the boy. Hit the big boy. Yes.
Oh, fuck.
He's back to full, but... Oh, he teleports. He's that's what he's doing.
Wily little bastard.
Oh, bugger. Oh, is he behind you?
I don't know. That's a wizard. Witch? Wizard.
Fucking witches.
Ugh.
Oh, it's on the right there. It's like, yeah. I think if you look at the smoke or something... Oh, back him into a corner. Yes. Jump as well. You can get like a
it's got
crit
again.
Hit.
Fucking disappeared again.
He's still there, I think. Just whipping around.
Piece
oh,
of shit.
Behind you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. Wail on him.
Oh, God, he's wailing on me.
Oh, the snowballs. I think the snowballs don't do much damage. They just knock you back. Yes!
Yes!
You did it!
We got it!
Get the boss crate. Get the boss crate. It's on the floor.
This thing?
Yeah, pick it up. Drop something else.
Yeah, we got it.
Doesn't matter what it is.
We got it.
Now eat some hearts.
Oh, God.
I can't believe it.
Got some hearts.
He did it!
We did it! look, with like half a health.
Jesus.
Oh my God.
Those hearty apples.
Jesus. We survive.
You
live.
Survive and you get the spoils.
My first run.
Your first run, you get a
world.
Boss crate. I can't
did
believe
all
it.
Of this work and I just...
I mean, I yeah.
In.
Still
but do. I've, it's low level, so it's like...
But we can be one. At the same amount of stuff, yeah. I think, for our first vault run. Like, we can have all this netherite stuff.
Yeah.
That's perfectly acceptable in vanilla.
Oh, my
perfectly
God.
Perfectly doable. So open that boss crate. I want to see what's
let's,
in it.
Let's have a look. What do I have to do? I have to put it somewhere specific or just
drop
just
it put
here?
It down anywhere.
Is that the one?
Oh, you also yeah. got that mystery thing as well.
Oh, the mystery... This thing.
That thing. You just right-click it in your hand. And you got...
Wool.
Some wool. Yay!
What's this one? Another crate?
Oh, so remember you had boss crates that yeah. I've given you.
Oh, right, okay.
Because you get to keep them. They're really big inventories.
What do I do? Okay, so
just right-click it.
Whoa.
What have we got here? So we've got cookies, which...
That levels you up. That's great.
Yeah. Vault bronze.
That's currency for buying cool
power
stuff.
Power bar, big old netherite sword.
Oh, that's really... Look at all the enchantments on there.
Yeah, right.
That's like all the best stuff.
Bending, sharpness, sweeping edge.
That's a really good sword.
Netherite scrap, which I'm guessing...
That's how you make netherite, yeah. that's a really rare disc. Sometimes comes up for the Vault Crystal ingredients.
Ghost Apple.
Ooh.
Power up gives you 50% parry.
Lots of enchanting.
Loads of emeralds, diamonds, and candy.
Very good.
Sweet. These ones, your ones.
Those is stuff that you've picked up, yeah.
So you can take these with you and just
fill them up. Yeah, so it's just more inventory space, basically. They did it. You've basically done Vault Hunters now. So it's not that bad.
No, it's not. I mean, early stage, definitely.
Early stage, not too bad.
It's doable, even in a state of panic and like, look at my fucking health.
Just a bit of guidance, sore needs.
Yeah.
And being prepared and having the right gear.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Level up. So get your cookies. I can show you this system briefly.
They were in a crate, right?
Boss crate. These cookies, there they are. Eat those. You see, you got almost like a whole level for doing that run.
Yeah. Oh, I see. I'm what, level one now. Yeah.
Level one now.
And
now you press H.
Big chunk on the way there.
To bring up that. And then you got different tabs. So your first tab
this one.
Is like active abilities where you have to push a button to do them, like dash and jump. And cleanse is a really good one.
Mega jump, dash. And then what's all this stuff?
This is like your passive. So this is stuff that increases your experience or reach.
Oh, that's good.
Reach Elvish is good. Negates fall damage. But I think that costs 5 points. That gives you more hearts. Well fit gives you more hearts, which is really good. Twerkers, that's the good one.
Water breathing,
instant water breathing, which is great.
So I can choose. So
you just click on it to like figure out more info.
Say water breathing,
and then you have to click learn to do it. So
it costs two, but I've only got one.
Yeah.
So yeah,
and that's basically it.
Stone skin.
I don't know what that does.
Knockback resistance, reducing amount of knockback projection.
Oh, so you know when the thing was snowballing you hard,
it wouldn't push me back. Yeah. Much.
Elvish reduces.
Oh.
Very cool.
This is
where you get stuff. All the mods.
Yeah.
And it costs you knowledge stars.
Well, yeah, look at that six. You can see why you haven't got like loads.
But, you know, you want all the decoration shit.
Yeah.
In this pack, when you unlock decoration mods, it reduces the cost of all the other mods.
Oh, okay.
So the more decoration ones you unlock, it minuses one from everything else.
Shit, that's pretty good.
So that's good.
My goodness.
You got 6 points, actually, yeah. You do have 6 points. Top right.
Oh, that's it. 6 points. Oh, right. I see. So
you're level
five?
One, but you've got 6 points for skills.
Okay.
So you could buy anything, really. Not the research stuff, but the other stuff. Any of this stuff.
It's cleansing.
That's the one that removes poison.
Ah, oh, that's quite a good one. Really Vein Miner seems like a good one as well.
That's a good one.
Boink.
And you can upgrade it like to make it bigger. Bigger blocks. Rampage is good.
I mean, obviously, this is just an example world. So
just playing about, yeah.
Hunter. Locate any mob within a radius around the player inside the vault by highlighting them.
I've not done that one before.
That can be seen through walls.
Yeah, it allows you to see mobs in the vault, but I've not tried that one.
Boink.
Okay, he's got it.
I've got it. Tank.
Oh, it just makes you super tanky. Bucket. Very useful.
Cleanse, one. Nice. Spent my points.
Widespread, and you can upgrade them that amount of pips as well.
Oh, this amount. Oh shit.
Yeah, I think it just reduces the cooldown, so you can get it back really quick. One run, one boss kill. Nuts.
It's a good example there.
Yeah, I think if you hold left alt. I can't remember the key bind for like bringing up the radial menu. I've remapped it to my mouse buttons, it's super easy. So, like, the back button brings up all your skills, and then the forward button.
Oh, there you go. That's my back button, yeah.
Oh, I've mapped it, of course. Yeah. So if you press that one, for example, just release on it.
Okay.
And then use the forward button on the mouse.
Oh, right, that activates it. Nice. Yeah, that's good.
That's how I've mapped it, yeah.
So
you can quickly switch.
It's a vein mine.
So you have to hold that down whilst you're mining.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so hold the forward button on the mouse and then mine something. And it, yeah, there you go. It's doing
nice,
more.
Nice, sweet.
But obviously, if you did that with
wrong
a
tool, I
shovel.
Triggered a lot of people there, sorry.
You can do it with Flamerang too, which is great.
Oh.
Hold that down and right click. Yeah, see, it's remote vein mining.
I like that.
It's really
good. These are the types of tools I probably want to use more out here.
Yeah.
Just because mining and grabbing stuff real quick and then.
Ding dong.
Lovely.
I forgot you had all my configs and everything as well.
Yes, yeah, so. It's a good setup. To be fair, yeah,
I could probably
when
just
we
do
start,
that.
We probably need to be on in sync in some
I'll
way. Just,
I'll make that pack, and then we but, can all download it.
But this is your solo world.
There we go. That's like a little.
It's a teaser.
Teaser.
It's a big teaser.
I think that's a positive, though.
Like, yeah.
Ross did a whole vault on his own, and killed a boss on his first try.
Yeah. Without much kind of. Experience in this.
I reckon had you not killed that boss, you would have gotten lost and run out of time.
Yeah, I think so. So that's definitely something to pay attention to.
Yeah.
Like getting lost.
Well, the great
or
thing
at least
is.
I'm going straight ahead, left, straight ahead, and mapping your way back.
All our XP and stuff is separate, so we can all unlock different mods ourselves, so you can go down a totally different path to what we get. Which is good. So you can just do it your own way.
Bloody nice.
Oh. Perfect. Well, I guess we'll read out some subbies then.
Oh, yes.
Nice way to round it off. Also, I want to get Twitch integration into this.
Oh, shit. Yeah, that was the other thing about this pack, wasn't it?
I just need to find out. That's why I had all the crazy tooltips. Yeah. I was trying to find out the tags for like those mystery boxes. Because it'd be great if people subbed and stuff.
Yeah,
we could drop some of those things for us.
Shit, that would be really cool. Yeah, get people involved as well.
Yeah.
They can kind of influence what happens. Because I remember we had that, what was it, sharks or something? Or was it alligators? It was crocodiles.
Yeah, it was bad stuff.
Where it's just people just spawning them in. But I'm sure we can find a way that makes it work.
Yeah.
In more of a, not so intrusive, but kind of an inclusive way.
Yeah.
For the audience as well.
You can randomize these things as well. So there's like a chance that you can get something good or something bad or something useless.
Shade is nice.
I won't make it overboard, of course. I'm not going to give us crazy stuff, but like
don't
mystery
make any
boxes
promises.
And things. Yeah, well,
you never know.
Oh, look, a full netherite set of gear, fully enchanted.
Got to get thinking on some assets, if that's.
Indeed, I need to start making some stuff.
If there's any, they already have. I just love the noises of them as well. The little popping boxes.
Yeah.
Because we did have the thing where they unboxed themselves each time. I mean, I'm sure we can make it more efficient.
I did that all in After Effects as well. Jesus.
Do you think you used After Effects again?
Yeah, I think so.
Like there's nothing really wrong with it. If anything, because everything was boxy.
Yeah, it helps.
It made
it
much easier to
animate
that.
I know Blender quite well nowadays, so I could probably easily do it in Blender. But it's easier to animate in After Effects.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
There we go. Nice. Leave that world.
Minecraft, everybody.
Bits of Minecraft.
I think it's a great mod pack. Like,
there's loads.
Give me stuff to do.
It seems like a lot.
Where did you get to with subbies?
Subbies. Let me just have a look. Got up to. Liu.
Nice.
27 Munter. Saying, yeah, boys.
Yeah.
And then there's a few more. So I'll read the rest. Simply Jarvis is a 38 monster saying, "Can't believe you finally killed Smith. How did you end up doing it?" Bath drowning. The Cruisinator is a 39 monster saying, "Dink bank bonk dun dun scrub scribe." Wow. That hurt my brain. Alec Razik is an 87 monster saying, "Oh good lord, I've been here for 7.5 years. I've been away, but glad for you nerds, loving the plate up stuff lately. I'm glad you're enjoying it, even though some people are very frustrated with our plays."
There's some meta strats that we do not adopt.
No, we're done.
For the pro players out there.
We're bad. And that's fine. It happens. Steve Zurich is a tier 2, 58 Munter, saying, "I hope you're doing well. Love the tier ranking. The fruit one was so funny. Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it. We'll do some more. We'll try and do something Halloween-y, I'm sure. Soon." Bertaroo is a 6 monster saying, "If you see something that doesn't look right, speak to staff or text the British Transport Police on 61016. We'll sort it. Say it." Oh, sorry. "See it, say it, vac trot." What a build up to that.
"See it, say it, vac trot."
He's only been vacked once, guys. Okay.
I've been vacked 3 times. Vaccinated.
Oh.
See what I did there?
Yeah.
Very vaxed. Smart.
Office Boy 11 is a freshie. Thank you very much for subbing. T Guz 91 is a 3 monter. Thank you. Joan Barosh it's a tier 2 18 monther saying sup. Thank you for your 18 months. Darren H is a fresh subby. Thank you. Dot Jinx is also a fresh subby. And another fresh subby, Darth Morph. Thank you for subscribing. And yeah, there's a lot of freshies. So yeah, maybe hyped for the Minecraft, perhaps.
Indeed.
But yeah, when there's an update, we'll we'll look into getting that on the go.
I mean, we can do this pack.
Mm.
If it's going to take a while for the new one to come out.
Yeah, see what we can do. Obviously, I mean, yeah, we've got other...
I'm hearing really good things about the new one, though, so maybe it is worth waiting for that one.
To be a part of the series. Otherwise, we'd be doing updates and stuff, I guess.
Indeed. So we'll have to think about it.
But we'll come back tomorrow. Get some Phasma on the go.
That's right. Some spooks, hopefully with Craigle.
Get some spookies. If Craig's free.
Lovely. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Mm-hmm. Have a great bloody day. See you tomorrow.
Ta-ra for me.
Bye. Oh, let's know who to read. Thanks. Bye.
Yep.
Bye. Alien unicorn head. Aliens with tits. Why the fuck not? I'm a pretty weird.